大家请坐。我们接下有一个，我不是卢牧师啊，不要搞错了。啊，我姓郭，汉城。哦，你帮翻译
，OK， 好，可以了。OK。怎么样介绍卢牧师呢？Well,
how do I introduce Reverend Lu?
他是一个不睡觉的牧师。
He's a
doesn't need to sleep.
Oh, doesn't need to sleep. Right. 不睡觉的牧师。
所以通常呢，有时候在香港那些的同工啊，或者国外的同工，如果要找他的话呢，大概是晚上12点到4点之间是最好的时候。So
all these church co-workers, be it in the country or out of the country, they want to look for him. They will look for him at between 12 a.m. to 4 a.m.
因为之前的时间呢，他有时候要开会。 要领会
Because all this time prior to that, he has services that need to lead. He has meetings to attend.
所以12点的时候，他就回去他的 office 来办公。
So he will go back to the office at midnight.
所以那时候就是最容易找他的时候了。
That's the best time to look for him.
当他要退休的时候，几年前要退休的时候。
So a few years ago, before he goes into retirement.
所以他们要找接班人。
He was looking for his successor.
那么就发觉很难。
They find it very difficult.
没有人愿意接他的位置。
And nobody wants to do his job.
因为他一个人做了4-5个人的工作。
Because a person alone is doing a job of 4 to 5 people.
卢牧师是真的很难去介绍他。
Well, it's really difficult to introduce Reverend Lu.
因为就一旦你把他介绍的时候，你已经把他缩小了，不好意思。
Well, because once you introduce him, you are like minimizing him.
他是很早期就参与社会工作。
Well, he's participated in the social work from very early on.
很早年，很多的教会的领袖啊，也不喜欢他的。
Well, in the beginning, many churches, church leaders do not like him.
因为这个人是好像是共产牧师。
Because this pastor looks like a communist pastor.
他是为贫穷人来发声。
Well, he voice up for the poor.
所以很多人觉得说你这个人哦，真的是不太像一个牧师啊，是所谓的中产牧师都是中产分子嘛啊，他就不像。
Well, he doesn't seem to be a pastor.
Yeah, doesn't seem to be a pastor. Even now.
Even now.
他是一个神学教育家。
But he is a theologian or educator.
Theological educator.
Theological educator.
他是做过神学院的院长很多年。
Well, he's been a principal of a seminary for many years.
大家在做院长的时候，就把那一个的神学院呢，本来就好像要关门的样子，就把它重新再来过，搞到很强大的一件神学院。
Well, this seminary at first it seems like it's going to close shop soon, but under his leadership, it has grown tremendously.
他是一个新约学者。
Oh, he's a New Testament scholar.
刚才大家都知道啊，他是专门研究保罗书，叫保罗神学，特别是罗马书。And
his research is around the Pauline.
Pauline, especially Romans.
Pauline, especially Romans.
他不知道今天晚上刚刚我要介绍他，他送了一本书给我。
Well, he didn't know I'm going to introduce him, and he gifted me a book.
这是刚刚就是关于罗马书的研究的著作。And
this is a research about Romans.
他是国际啊，这个世界上面新约学者 James Dunn 啊，一个著名学者的得意门子。Well,
he is a pupil of a very famous
beloved
pupil of a world famous scholar James Dunn.
他是卫理公会的牧师。He's
a pastor in the Methodist Church.
他也曾经做过香港寻道卫理公会的会长。
He's also been the president of the Hong Kong
Methodist Church.
Right?
你知道我马来西亚，我做会长是全职的。
Well, you know that in Malaysia, me being a president of CAC is a full-time job.
他同时间做会长，又做神学院的院长。
Well, at the same time, he was a president. He's also a principal of the seminary.
所以你就可以说是不睡觉的牧师。
He's a pastor that that's never sleep.
啊，多讲几句啊。
Well, a few more words.
顶多晚上给他拔光我的头发。 他的太太啊，师母是一位的教育学院啊，教育大学的教育家。Well,
his wife is a educator in a education university.
女儿坚玲啊，是一位新闻工作者。The
daughter works in the news.
儿子坚森是啊，在读的大学医学课。
The son 在读着吗？
读着，孩子还准备要毕业，还有两年就要毕业。
The son is in the medical school.
有人说在香港，如果能够在香港做读医学大学医学科毕业的话，你全世界什么地方都可以做得了。
Well, somebody said that if you can do medics in Hong Kong University, then you can work anywhere in the world.
啊，多讲一两句啊。
A few more points.
我认识他的时候是在1976年。
I knew him since year 1976.
那时候是我刚刚读神学，他也在神学刚要毕业了啊。我们就在青少年事工那边就开始认识。
Well, that time I was in seminary, he was also there, and we were working in the youth work.
在1982年，他问了我一个问题。
In 1982, he asked me a question.
当时香港的宣道会理会要做一些的海外宣教的关怀。
Well, at that time, the Hong Kong Methodist churches, they're looking at doing an overseas mission work.
所以他就问我，马来西亚的原住民施工是怎么样？
So he asked me, how's the work of Orang Asli in Malaysia?
我在金宝出世的。
Well, I'm born in Kampar.
金宝就有很多 Orang Asli 的了。
So there are a lot of Orang Asli in Kampar.
I know nothing.
但是我一点都，我一无所知啊。
但是他一个香港人问我这个问题，要我去介绍马来西亚的原住民施工。
But him coming from Hong Kong, he's asking me a Malaysian, to tell me about Orang Asli.
几十年后我还记得。
So I still remember this now many years ago, later.
香港的他们那种的视野啊。比我们早了很多很多年。
The vista of the people of Hong Kong has been years ahead of us.
很多地方他的经验大概可以给我们很多的一些思考。
Well, in many places, his experience is going to give us a lot of food for thought.
所以我们盼望他今天晚上能够多给我们一些的思考，把他一些人生经验多讲一点的，不要紧的。
So I truly hope that he can help us to think even more, tell us about his life experience.
在我读神学的时候，他也给我很多的指示。
Well, even when I was studying in seminary, he's given me a lot of guidance.
当我要做院长的时候，他是给我很多的提醒。
When I was going to be a principal of seminary, he gave me a lot of reminders.
当我做会长的时候，他说无药可救了。
When I became the president, he said I'm beyond redemption.
Yeah, 所以谢谢他。
So thank you.
今天晚上我们特别很高兴，他能够继续跟我们分享他的一些的思考，他的人生的经验。
This morning we are glad and honored to have him sharing with us again.
Don't be too excited. It's not morning.
Oh, this evening. Brothers and sisters, a very good evening. Your president took a lot of my time. Well, during the prayer, it was prayed that I had a lot of durian, so I have a lot of power today.
但我现在害怕我是吃太多了，讲不出道来。
Well, now I'm afraid that I've had too much, and I can't preach anymore.
但其实今天晚上应该是 Philip 讲，我在翻译的嘛。
But tonight it should be Philip preaching, and I'll translate.
所以现在我们这个互动不晓得是谁在讲道哈。
So now with the interaction, we don't know who's preaching.
好，我们这个营会呢其实很短的啊。
Well, this retreat is really short.
就三天两夜。
Three days, two nights.
但我相信像美加堂那么多弟兄姐妹愿意来参加这样的个退休会啊，实在不简单。
But I believe it's not a simple feat that many brothers and sisters from MegaCMC willing to come for the retreat.
不但是很多弟兄姐妹在筹备上面花了很多的心思时间。
There's a lot of planning and time spent on organizing this.
而且我知道弟兄姐妹来参加，你们也要做了很多不同的准备，以及大家有很多的投入。
And even though and even for everyone that comes, I know that you need to make a lot of preparation to be here.
很明显，我知道何牧师要退休的时候，他为了美加堂而感恩，而且应该觉得有点。
Well, I know that the Reverend Ho will be retiring. It's obviously he should be proud of Mega CMC. Because the pastoral for the past 20 over years.
将这个教会建立起来。
It's built this church.
将弟兄姐妹建立起来。
And it's built the body of the brothers and sisters, body of church.
其实在刚才会长呢讲的很多的不需要讲的话哈。
Well, actually, President said a lot of things that he didn't need to mention.
其实最重要的话他没讲。
But the most important thing he missed out.
我做了42年的牧师哈。
I was a pastor for 42 years.
我有16年是全时间在堂会里面牧养的。
I pastored church full time for 16 years.
然后我才去神学院当老师做院长。
And only after that, I became a teacher in a seminary and became the principal.
香港包括马来西亚没有哪个神学院长是那么长时间在堂会里面侍奉，然后才去神学院。
Well, in Hong Kong, even in Malaysia, there are not that many principals that would have done so many years of pastoring before they became a principal.
所以呢，很多神学院的院长等不知道牧养那种的困难的。
So a lot of seminary principals they do not understand the difficulty of pastoring a church.
那一种像保罗说的，像看照顾孩子那种的眼泪啊，那种痛苦啊，那种被误会啊，那种压力啊，不是一般没做过堂会牧师知道的。
So the tears, the suffering, being wronged by other people, these are the things that many pastors will not understand.
所以明天早上我们为了何牧师的感恩会啊，大家好好的去感谢何牧师啊。
So for the Thanksgiving, for the ceremony tomorrow, you really got to give thanks to Reverend Ho.
但是当然当神学院院长也不容易的。
But and to become a principal of a seminary is also not easy.
常常被那些牧师也去误会那个神学院的。
被牧师？
被堂会牧师啊。
啊，会怎么呢？
Those pastors in the local church always misunderstood the difficulties of the principal.
哇，这很多牧师就误会这个会长啊，院长。
因为他们就怨那些神学院的院长怎么培养那些牧师都不中用的。
Well, they say, well, how did this seminary train up the pastor that doesn't seem to be useful?
所以那互相在埋怨啊。
So they start to blame each other.
啊，所以我就最懂这两种的情况的。
So I understand both sides.
因为呢，堂会牧师就说你怎么没有培养一好的啊牧师给我们用。
So the pastors in churches say, well, you did not train good pastors for us.
那神学院院长呢就说了。
Well, then the principals of seminary, they say,
你的来料不好啊。
Well, your raw material is not good.
那我3-4年怎么能够令他脱胎换骨呢？
Well, in these 3-4 years, how can I change them completely?
啊，所以往往在彼此埋怨啊。
So they blame each other.
但其实今天我们这教会最重要的是同心合意。
But most importantly today, churches need to work in one accord.
彼此配搭
and partner with one another.
啊，我今天下午很开心，因为爱人呢就记得我1年前说的话。
Well, this afternoon I was really glad because brother Iron remembered this thing that I said a year ago.
我说教会是同心合意，不是同心要同意哦。
I said the church is
With one heart, but no need to be one in one opinion.
In one heart, but doesn't need to be in one opinion.
华语啊，
啊，就是同心合意，但是不需要同心同意啊。
对，好啊，我们要合意。
We need to have one heart.
合意。
We need to
integration of different opinions.
我们需要合一，
合意，
合意，
这个意见要不同的意见。
We need to have 要不同的意见合起来吗？
整合起来 ，integration。
We need to integrate the different opinions,
but not to make into one opinion.
但是不要做成只有一个意见。
哎，真好
，very good。
所以我们需要配搭的。
So we need partnership.
我们的专职的牧者跟信徒，我说这个信徒也是牧者来的。
Well, the pastors.
Yeah, pastor is professional pastor, and all the lay people are lay pastor. They are also pastor. You are also pastor.
你也是一个牧者。
所以一个专职的牧者要跟信徒的牧者要彼此配合的好。
The professional pastors and the lay pastors needs to partner together.
我看到每家堂就有这种情况。
So I see that in Mega CMC.
而且我更希望就是我像何牧师也一样，一代到一代都会教会被上帝所兴起不同的仆人来侍奉主。
And even more so, I truly hope, just like Reverend Ho, that the Lord will rise up new leaders in different generations.
所以今天晚上我要继续讲这个神在世代中。
So this evening I'm going to talk about God at generations.
我昨天晚上特别是用旧约的六对的人物。
So in last night I spoke about six characters from the Old Testament.
讲到摩西跟约书亚，
Moses and Joshua，
大卫跟所罗门，
David and Solomon，
以利亚跟以利沙，
Elijah and Elisha，
他们都各有不同的地方。
They are all different，
而他们就在他们的世代服侍了上帝。
But in their generation they serve God，
而他们在做一些不同的事情。
And they were doing different things，
而共同的就是他们都是软弱的人。
But the similarity is that they were all weak people.
他们的人生，我们从人的角度来看，总是有不同的遗憾。
Well, in their lives, from a perspective of human, there seem to be always their regrets.
但我们看到他们自己知道上帝是他们的主，他们都满足他们的生命。
But they see themselves, they know that God is their Lord.And they were satisfied of what they've done in their life.
因为他们得到上帝的喜悦。
Because they were pleasing to God.
不是从人的角度来看他的成功或失败。
Their success or failure is not defined by a human's perspective.
更不是用人的角度看他们的表现是有那么多好。
And it's not to be judged through human perspective on how good they have performed.
他们都服侍了他们的个时代。
They've served their generation.
所以今天晚上呢，我就讲两对新约的人物。
So this evening I'm going to talk about two pairs of characters
the New Testament.
In the New Testament. Yes.
然后最后呢，有时间的话呢，因为会长用了很多时间哈，所以呢，有时间我就讲我自己哈。
Well, if we still have time, then I'll talk about myself.
那第一对人是谁呢？
So the first pair of people, who are they?
我要讲的是施洗约翰跟耶稣。
I want to talk about John the Baptist and Jesus Christ.
回到教会一段的时间，人当然都很认识新约圣经的。
Well, many people in churches, you'll be familiar with the New Testament.
施洗约翰大概大家都认识他。
John the Baptist, I believe everyone would know him.
施洗约翰跟耶稣是亲戚来的。
Well, John the Baptist and Jesus, they were relative.
他是表哥，耶稣是表弟。
Well, they're cousin. John the Baptist is the older cousin, and Jesus is the younger one.
而且大家知道，施洗约翰为耶稣洗礼。
And we all know that John the Baptist baptized Jesus.
而且在施洗的时候，最重要的事情发生了。
And something really important happened during the baptism.
有什么重要的事情呢？
And what was it?
耶稣是什么时候确认他是上帝的儿子的身份的呢？
Well, when did Jesus confirm that he is the Son of God?
有人以为他一出生就知道了。
Well, some people think that, he knew it from the day he's born.
或者有人说，哎，他十二岁在圣殿的时候，他说我应该以我父的家为念啊，所以他们很多人就以为说啊，你看耶稣十二岁的时候就知道他是上帝儿子的身份。
So, or some say that because in the temple he said that I should be concerned about the matters of my father, and that was when they think that he knew that he's the son of God.
其实犹太人里面用以圣殿为父的家，这个不是耶稣才那么特别的。
Well, in the Jews, it's not just Jesus that would say this.That the temple is the house of the Father.
我们知道耶稣是百分之百的人，也是百分之百的神。
We know that Jesus is 100% man, he's also 100% God.
我们自己什么时候开始寻找我们自己的身份的？
知道。
When do you search your own identity?
我们自己什么时候寻找我们自己的身份呢？
幼稚园的时候，我们不会寻找。
Well, when you're in kindergarten, you will not search.
我慢慢的小学的中学才来开始问我是谁啊。
Well, in primary school, in secondary school, then you ask, who am I?
或者会怀疑啊，我是我爸爸妈妈的儿子啊。
Or you might even doubt, what am I, the son or daughter of my father?
但是我妈妈整天骂我，这个妈妈是不是我妈妈来的啊？
Well, my mommy always scold me, so is this really my real mom?
那我们整天要作文说我的志愿。
Well, when they write an essay, they always write, my ambition.
你知道那个幼稚园呢、啊？很多时候现在也开始说要我的志愿是什么呢
？You know, even now in kindergarten, they make the children write, "Oh, what's my ambition?"
最多人你知道他们想当什么吗
？You know what many people write, what they want to be.
所以你们的孩子，你幼稚园问他你想当什么呢
？Well, your children in kindergarten, you ask them, "What do you want to be?"
我们香港的幼稚园毕业典礼的时候，他们出来讲啊。
Well, some in their kindergarten graduation, they come out and talk about it.
我想当个警察。
I want to be police.
我当消防员。
I want to be a firefighter.
哎，怎么搞的？就当这个很少人说要当医生啊、律师的哦。
Well, 很少吗？
很少啦。
Well, we say, well, why do they think about this? Well, very little of people talk about they want to be doctors or lawyers.
因为幼稚园都是玩那些消防车嘛，哈。
Because in kindergarten they play the fire engines.
其实他们都不懂啊。
So they don't really know.
但是大家大概到了中学的时候。
But when they enter into secondary school.
开始很认真问，哎呀，我是谁啊
？They ask this question seriously. Who I am? Who am I?
我想干嘛
？What should I be doing?
我一生人里面，我希望做些什么事
？In my life, what do I want to be?
其实每一个人的那个成长的过程都差不多这样子。
Well, if everyone's their growing years is about the same.
到现在因为我们的年轻人很幸福他们也不需要要去所谓我们要完食啊他们不需要完食现在啊所以父母都给他吃到三十岁了啊
So the young people nowadays they don't really need to think about how to cari makan right because the parents or will feed them up to 30 years
哇这个我不懂啊什么 cari makan
这完食啊
所以你问的大学生他都不晓得自己想干嘛了
So even university graduateThey don't know what they want to be.
耶稣也是一个人来的。
So Jesus was a human.
他其实跟你跟我一样。
He is like you and me.
他在寻找他自己的方向。
So he was seeking for his directions.
他在思考他要干嘛。
He was thinking, what should I be? What should I do?
而施洗约翰他在他施洗的时候。
So when John the Baptist baptized him.
最重要的是天上有声音说。
The most importantly is there is a voice in the Heaven,
你是我的爱子。
You are my beloved son.
我喜悦你。
I love you. I love you.
然后圣灵像鸽子一样落在耶稣的身上。
And Holy Spirit, descends upon Jesus Christ like a dove.
这是圣经里面很清楚的，是耶稣受洗礼的时候，上帝跟他说：“你是我的儿子。”
This happens very clearly that during the baptism that God told Jesus that you are my beloved son.
然后你回去看圣经，就发现施洗以后第一件发生的事，耶稣就到旷野去了。
Well, you can see that in the Bible very clearly it stated that after Jesus was baptized, he went into the wilderness.
立刻受到撒旦的试探。
He was tempted by Satan.
我们今天很多时候说，你看我们也受试探，耶稣也受试探。
Well, many times you say, well, we were tempted and Jesus was tempted.
对呀，我们常常受试探啊。
Yeah, we are tempted many times.
就像我今天下午就受很大的试探。
Just like this afternoon I was tempted.
因为我本来已经吃了很多榴莲了。
Well, because I already had a lot of durian.
哎呀，当然苏青又，哎呀，这个也是很好的。
But then Su Chen said, well, this is also really good.
我说，哎呀，吃的很多了吧。
I said, I already had a lot.
但一看，哎呦，又很吸引人。
Oh, but it's really attractive.
啊，又吃了。
Okay, one more.
然后就，哎呀，很饱了，很饱了。
Oh, I'm really full.
哇，然后那个 Joseph 又来了哈。
Then Joseph came.
说，哎，这个我是我岳父啊，从很远那边带来的哈。
Well, this one is from my father-in-law, came from far, far away land.
哇，这个是猫山王啊。
This is Musan King.
哇，很好的啊。
It's really good.
一看
，I take a look.
很饱啦
really full.
晚上要讲到啦
I got to preach tonight.
再吃就讲不出来啦
If I eat again, I can't preach.
他说不 不是会的，不会的，很好。
Say, well, Pastor, it's okay, but this is really good.
我一看，啊，又吃了。
Okay, then I took and eat one.
哎，这个就是试探。
Well, that's temptation.
但耶稣不是这些试探哦。
But Jesus, the temptation that came to Jesus was not like this.
你说，哎，是啊，不是也是关于吃东西吗？
Well, yeah, but you said it's also about food.
啊，耶稣不是四十天没吃东西？
Well, wasn't it recorded that Jesus did not eat for 40 days?
然后撒旦就来了。
Then Satan came.
就跟他说了。
And said,
说什么？你记得吗？
Do you remember what he said?
啊，你就说叫他将石头变为食物了。
Well, he said, well, tell God to turn this stone to become food.
Jesus, not God, huh? Jesus turned the stone.
Well, ask Jesus to turn the stone into food.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. 我讲英语，你讲不讲英语啊？
这叫耶稣就把这个石头变成食物。
你看圣经要小心哈。
Well, when you read the Bible, you got to be careful.
这个问题之前一个最重要的试探是什么？
这个问题之前。So before this question, what was the most important temptation?
其实在那三次的撒旦的对话里面，两次的开头就是，假如你是神的儿子。
Well, actually, in that three conversation, the first two conversations started off with,If you are the Son of God,
那你可以将石头变为食物。
Tell this stone to become bread.
耶稣刚刚受洗的时候，确认了他的身份是上帝的儿子。
Well, when Jesus was baptized, he confirmed his identity to be the Son of God.
是跟着第一个试探就是你真的吗
？So the first temptation was, is that true?
你真的是上帝儿子
？Are you really the son of God？
假如你是上帝儿子，你可以将石头变为食物。
Well, if you are the son of God, then tell the stone to become bread.
假如我是耶稣的话
，Well, if I'm Jesus，
我就变给你看。
Well, then I'll just make it happen.
我当然可以啊。
Of course I can.
而且我四十天没吃东西了。
Well, further to that, 40 days I've not had food.
我吃东西算什么试探呢、啊、
？Well。Food is no temptation at all.
不像我们吃饱了又要吃，那才是试探嘛，对吧
？Well, it's not like us. We are already filled, and yet we are asked to eat some more. That's real temptation.
但耶稣没有这样做。
But Jesus did not do that.
耶稣说，人活着不是单靠食物。
He says that man doesn't live on bread alone.
乃是靠上帝口里的话。
But through the words of God.
我们小时候就以为，哦，那就是叫我们多看圣经啦。
When we were young, we said, "Well, then that means that we need to read more Bible."
因为圣经去抵抗这个魔鬼的试探嘛。
Well, and use the Bible to fight against the temptation of Satan.
但你看到第二个试探就糟糕了。
But then you see the second temptation.
原来魔鬼也很熟圣经的哦。
Well, looks like Satan also very familiar with Bible.
他用圣经来试探耶稣啊。
Well, he used the Bible to tempt Jesus.
他假如你是上帝的儿子。
He says that if you are the Son of God.
圣经里面记载说，你可以从圣殿跳下来，上帝的使者会拖住你，不会受伤的。
And he says that you can just jump off from the highest point, and the angels can lift you up in their hands.
Yeah, according to the scripture.
According to the scripture.
耶稣拒绝他。
So Jesus rejected, declined.
所以你不可以试探上帝。
He says, do not put the Lord your God to the test.
这两个试探都强调，假如你是上帝的儿子。
Well, these both temptations started off with if you are the son of God.
而且我们知道，耶稣前面的道路其实就是要让人认识他是上帝的儿子。
Because we know that the path ahead of Jesus is to have people to know that he is the son of God.
所以彼得门徒当耶稣问他们说：“你们说我是谁？”
So when disciple Peter, apostle Peter, will ask, well, what do people say? Who am I?
Jesus asked them,
what do you say? What do they say? Who am I?
然后他说，你是基督，是永生上帝的儿子。
You are Christ. You are the Son of our ever living God.
但耶稣说，你不要告诉别人。
Don't tell anyone about this. He said.
然后我们看到了最后，约翰福音写到。圣经的目的的时候
，So when you look at the purpose of the Bible in the Gospel of John,
at the end it says, "I write this because I want you to know Jesus is Christ and the Son of God."
那最后他就写这个目的呢，就是要你知道耶稣基督他是神的儿子。
所以我们知道啊，这个圣经里面新约 特别福音书的核心就是耶稣是谁。
Well, the core tenet of the New Testament talks about who Jesus is.
而耶稣就在他受洗的时候确认，这个确认不是他自己说，哎，我就是上帝儿子，是圣灵降临在他身上，上帝告诉他，确认他的身份，你是我的爱子，我喜悦你。
But Jesus has did confirm during his baptism that when Holy Spirit descended upon him and God spoke to him and said, You are my beloved son.
但是撒旦就立刻来试探他了。
But immediately Satan came to tempt him.
假如你能够解决人家完成的问题、啊、
Cari makan. Well,、嗯、if you can solve this problem of Cari makan,
那人家就承认你是上帝的儿子啦。
Well, then they will recognize.They will confirm that you are the Son of God.
但耶稣拒绝了。
But Jesus declined.
因为他说，人活着不是单靠食物。
Because he says man does not live on bread alone.
因为靠上帝口里的话。
But by the word of God.
什么意思啊？
What does that mean?
不是多读圣经而已啊。
It doesn't mean to just read more Bible.
是问题就是说，人跟那些猫狗最不同的差别在哪里啊？
It says,Well, what's the biggest difference between man and the animals, cats and dogs?
你家里面就有答案了。
Well, you have this answer in your home.
我在马来西亚很多人也养狗养猫的嘛哈。
So in Malaysia, many people have pets, pet cats and pet dogs.
你有没有发现，当你那个猫啊狗不听话，你在骂它哈
？When you do you realize that when your pet is not obedient and you scold them?
但是他肚子饿，骂完你给他东西吃，他会怎么样
？Well.If they're hungry, you scold them. After that, you give them food. What do they do?
Boom, 又去吃了。
Well, they just jump to the food and start eating.
假如你在家里开饭的时候
well, if at home during the meal time,
你讲了你的儿女几句而已啊。
Well, you just reprimand your children a few lines, a few things.
然后你说，哎，开饭了。
You say, okay, let's eat.
他怎么说
？What would they say?
不吃。
I'm not gonna eat.
这个就猫狗跟人的分别，你知道吗
？So that's the difference between cats and dogs and human.
其实猫狗跟人都要吃饭的嘛。
Well, you see that man and even cats and dogs, we all need to eat.
对啊 ，orang 什么实力嘛，啊 ？orang 什么
？Cari makan.
Cari makan. Orang 是他讲的，是原住民。
对对。
人要完成啊。
Well, people need to cari makan.
但人不单单靠食物才生存的吗
？But man does not live on bread alone.
所以你的孩子说我不吃。
So your children say, I'm not going to eat.
我现在没有尊严了。
Well, I'm losing my dignity.
我被你冤枉。
I'm wronged by you.
我觉得不爽。
I don't feel good.
我就不吃。
So I'm not going to eat.
所以人会自杀的。
Well, that's why there's suicide.
人会。禁食或者是绝食
，so there are people that refuse to eat, they fast or they even refuse to eat.
来抗议当权者
，they do that to show their rejection, their opposition.
因为人跟猫狗不同的地方就是说，我们要确认我们吃的意义在哪里。
Because that's the difference between us and animals. We want to confirm the reason, the meaning of us eating.
我不是为了活着而活着。
Well, I don't live.Just to live.
我要问我活着有什么价值，有什么意义的。
I'm gonna ask what's the meaning of my life. What's the value of my life?
回应这个撒旦的这个试探。
So Jesus responded to Satan.
我当然有这个能力，但是我这个不是我要人认识我是上帝儿子的原因。
Well, of course I have the power, but this is not the reason.Why I want people to know that I'm the Son of God.
So, 耶稣喂饱五千人的时候
，So when Jesus fed the 5,000 people,
假如是我的话，我应该是立刻呼召他们跟从耶稣嘛。
Well, if it's me, then I would at that point in time do the altar call for them to follow Jesus.
但耶稣是，哎，怎么那么这么大声啊？啊，声音小一点，我都吓坏自己了。耶稣是静悄悄的走了。
But Jesus.Went away quietly.
因为他说他不要那些喂饼而来的人。
Because he doesn't want people that came for the bread.
因为他要人家知道他是上帝的儿子。
Because he wants people to know that he is the son of God.
不是靠因为他能够给他们吃饱。
not because that he could feed them.
不是因为满足他们的生活生存的需要。
Not because that he could satisfy their needs of their lives.
说当彼得门徒们承认说你是基督永生上帝的儿子。
So when Peter and disciples confirmed or recognized that he is,
confessed.
Or confessed that he is the Son of God.
但耶稣说你不要告诉别人。
Jesus said, "Don't tell anyone."
那么奇怪，我们今天不是整天传福音说耶稣是主，耶稣是上帝儿子吗？
Isn't that strange that when we share gospel, we often say that Jesus is the Son of God. He's the Son of God.
为什么耶稣反而叫他门徒说，哎，不要告诉别人？
But why did Jesus say, "Don't tell anyone on this"?
然后耶稣告诉他说，我会受害，我会钉十字架，我会死，被害死，然后才从死人中复活。
And Jesus said, "I will be persecuted, and I will die." And I will then resurrect.
为什么耶稣不喜欢他们告诉别人呢？
Why did Jesus not like them telling people of this?
当耶稣赶鬼的时候，鬼说：“我知道你是谁，你就是大卫的子孙。”
When Jesus chased away demon, and the demon said, "I know who you are the son of David."
但耶稣说：“你住口。”
He said, "Shut up."
不要讲。
Don't tell.
为什么这样？
Why was it?
因为那个时候耶稣还没有钉十字架嘛。
Because at that point in time, Jesus had not yet been crucified.
耶稣不要人家去讲一些他还没做的事。
Jesus doesn't want people to talk about things that he had yet to accomplish.
他知道他自己走一条十字架的道路。
He knows he's going on the way of the cross.
他不是靠满足人的吃饱啊、医病啊等等这些，令到人家承认他是上帝的儿子。
He knows that his way of helping people to know that he's the Son of God is not through satisfying their daily needs or through healings of people.
他也不要从双子塔跳下来不会死来证明他是上帝的儿子。
And he also doesn't want to prove that he is the Son of God by jumping off the Petronas Twin Towers and yet not die.
你说，哎，圣经说圣殿呢，怎么变成双子塔呢？
He said, God said it's the temple, why the Twin Towers?
所以你读圣经呢，一定要 update 的哈。
Well, when you read Bible, you got to update yourself.
因为耶稣那时候圣殿是最高的嘛。
Because during that time, the temple was at the highest point.
假如今天有个布道家能够从双子塔跳下来不死的话，哇，大概全马来西亚70%吧，哈，的人都可能相信耶稣是基督了。
Well, if you think if you have an evangelist that could jump off the Twin Towers and yet not die, I guess 70% of Malaysians.You believe that Jesus is God.
大家都很希望有这种超自然的神迹出现。
Well, many of us expect or would like to see this kind of supernatural act.
有捷径，令人信耶稣多好啊！
If there's a shortcut to help people to understand to know Jesus, ain't that good?
但耶稣拒绝了。
But Jesus declined.
耶稣不走捷径。
Jesus doesn't take shortcut.
耶稣不要这种所谓超自然的那种的表现。
He doesn't want that kind of supernatural performance.
来吸引人家跟随他。
To attract people to follow him.
他要人是每天背起十字架来跟从他。
He wants people to carry their cross every day to follow him.
在他们日常的生活里面来跟从他。
And that they will follow him in their daily lives.
他要走的是那条十字架的道路。
His way is the way of the cross.
我们知道耶稣，我们谁能够像他了？
We all know that who can be like Jesus.
但是我今天要讲的就是这样一位耶稣是100%的人。
But today, what we want to talk about is that Jesus is 100% human.
然后也是100%的神。
But he is also 100% God.
而他在人的表现上面，我们可以去学他的。
We can learn from him on how he was being a human.
但是他跟他的表兄施洗约翰的关系就是那么微妙。
But that's how miracle, how
微妙 subtle
is his relationship between John the Baptist and himself.
施洗约翰是他的表哥。
Oh, yes, John the Baptist is his cousin.
而且为他施洗。
And he baptized him.
哇，参与了神的在那个世代很重要的工作。
And participated in very important work of God in that generation.
就在那个时刻，耶稣才确认上帝的儿子是他的身份。
And at that moment, Jesus confirmed his identity being the Son of God.
他跟着受了魔鬼的试探。
And subsequently, he was tempted by Satan.
然后你跟着看圣经，他从试探出来以后，就开始他十字架的道路了。
Well, if you read the Bible, it says that from that temptation, then he started the way of cross.
所以施洗约翰扮演了一个好像是很普通的角色吗？
Well, you look at it, you say, well, John the Baptist looks to be playing a very simple role.
但是他却扮演一个很重要的角色。
But truly, he's played a very important role.
所以呢，在圣经里面，我们往往很这个没有很重视施洗约翰他的工作。
So many times we've not placed any emphasis on the work of John the Baptist.
我们只觉得是约翰是在这个前面跑路的，要开路的人。
Well, we all think that the John the Baptist is a person, it's a pioneer that opened the path.
其实别忘记他是他的表哥。
But don't forget that he's his cousin.
不要忘记他替耶稣施洗。
Well, don't forget that he baptized Jesus.
哎，他是老大来的。
Well, he's the older person.
但是在圣经里面描写施洗约翰的有两段的经文，我希望今天晚上提醒大家。
Well, there are two verses about John the Baptist that I want to use to remind you this evening.
我今天准备了一些 PowerPoint 哈。
So today I have some PowerPoint.
因为大家可能没圣经啊，这个经文就打出来了。嘿，我怎么
样？Now you can see that on the screen.
嘿啊啊！大家三章二十五到三十节，我们看到有没有英文的哈？不然就要这个 Philip 去翻。
Okay,
有英文有中文，可不可以一个打英文，一个打中文呢哈？啊，这个科技哈，没有的话，那就先看有中文啊，那边有没有英文？好，我们就先看中文哈。我们一起来念啊，有英文的大概你们都有 handheld， 你们看英文的就不需要 Philip 去翻译了啊。那我们一起来念这个中文啊。约翰的门徒和一个犹太人辩论洁净的理，就来见约翰说：“拉比，从前同你在约旦河外，你所见证的那位，现在施洗，众人都往他那里去了。”约翰说：“若不是从天上赐的，人就不能得什么。”我曾说我不是基督，是奉差遣在他前面的，你们自己可以给我做见证。娶新妇的就是新郎，新郎的朋友站着听见新郎的声音就甚喜乐，故此我这喜乐满足了。他必兴旺，我必衰微。英语怎么讲 Philip 最后那句找到没有？
找到了。Verse 30, he must become greater, I must become less.
这句话一点都不简单哈。
This is no simple phrase.
我很多人都希望会问，我是谁啊？
Well, many people ask, who am I?
我是老大啊。
Well, I'm the boss.
我是会长啊。
I'm the president.
我是老爸啊。
Well, I'm your dad.
我是老板啊。
I'm the boss.
但是施洗约翰他很清楚他是谁啊。
But John the Baptist, he knows clearly who he is.
他本来说我是表哥啊。
He said, I'm the cousin.
我替他施洗的啊。
Well, I baptize him.
我比他早出道啊。
Well, I'm out in the ministry first.
人家都来我那里听我讲道啊。
Everyone come to listen to me.
啊，怎么今天搞什么的跑到我表弟去那里了？
Well, how come everyone goes to my younger cousin?
那不是跟我竞争吗？
Well, isn't that a competition?
我不是应该老大的吗？
Well, am I the elder?
但施洗约翰很清楚。
But John, he's very clear.
我是为他开路的。
He knows that he's there to open the path.
我不是基督。
I'm not Christ.
他必兴旺。
He must become greater.
我必衰微。
I must become less.
为什么在不同的世代有不同的人被兴起呢？
Why are there different people being raised up in different generations?
欢迎何牧师要参加我这个退休牧师的行列了。
Well, I want to welcome a Reverend Ho to the line of retired pastors.
可以很不开心的哈，我告诉你哈。
Well, it can be not very pleasant.
但又可以很开心的哈。
But yet you can be very happy too.
就是看你怎么去面对。
So it really depends on how you face it.
面对我们的后来的接续我们的人。
How do you face your successor?
我们看到后来的人
We look at our successors.
中国人很喜欢说一句话，就是哎呀，一代不如一代。
Well, Chinese like to say that generations become, well, it's not as good as the previous generation.
哎呀，那些年轻怎么搞的？
Well, what's going on with the young people?
啊，都看不顺眼。
Well, you look at that, you say no good.
跟我同时候的很多的退休的那些什么总干事啊等等啊，很多都是对后来继任人都不太满意的。
Well, many people that retired at the same time with me, they were not satisfied with their successors.
总觉得他们都不太行了。
They always say, "Oh, they're not very good."
我相信何牧师不会这样。
I believe Reverend Ho would not be like that.
因为施洗约为我们做了很好的一个见证。
Because John the Baptist has given us a great testimony.
我希望我们弟兄姐妹也同样的。
I hope that brothers and sisters are like that too.
你会欣赏那些年轻的人。
That you admire the younger people.
他跟你不一样的。
Well, they're going to be different from you.
他很多东西不同意你的。
Well, many things they might not agree with you.
你肯定很不同意他们的。
And you will disagree with them too.
但你不要以为你是老大。
But don't think you are the greater person.
新的世代。
Well, a new generation.
不同的世代。
A different generation.
上帝才是主。
Only God is the master.
他就会兴起不同的人来侍奉他。
And he will raise up different people to serve him.
那些在前面的人。
Those people that has come first.
有没有这种的谦卑？
Do they have that humbleness?
有没有这种的欣赏？
Can they admire these people?
这种的支持。
The support.
当然在适合的时候也应该有不同的提醒。
Of course, at different time,You can also have different reminders.
但是我们肯定就是不同的世代，上帝就用不同的人来做他的工。
But one thing for sure is that God, at different generations, we use different people for His work.
不同的角色
，for different roles.
所以使徒约翰很清楚他自己的角色。
So John the Baptist is very clear about his role.
他愿意说，他必兴旺，我必衰微。
He said, "He must, I must become greater. He must become greater. I must become less."
而我们看到耶稣基督也很谦卑啊。
And we see that Jesus Christ, he was very humble too.
他愿意接受施洗约翰的施洗。
And he was willing to be baptized by John the Baptist.
甚至后来施洗约翰坐牢以后，他开始怀疑，哎呀，耶稣是不是那个要来的那一位啊？
In fact, even after John was jailed, he started to doubt whether Jesus was the one.
因为他也不明白耶稣在干嘛。
Because even he did not understand what Jesus was doing.
说他派他的门徒来问耶稣，你究竟是不是那一位啊？
So he sent his own disciple to ask Jesus, "Are you really the one?"
耶稣回答，告诉他，告诉约翰，瞎眼的看见，瘸腿的行走。
Well, then Jesus told the disciple, "Tell John that the blind can see, the lame can walk."
告诉施洗约翰。他在做的事情的核心
Well, tell him the core of the work that he's doing.
但是他就称赞施洗约翰
And he praised John the Baptist.
没有后来先知会比施洗约翰更大的
There will be no prophet that will be greater than John the Baptist.
施洗约翰在怀疑他的时候
So even when John the Baptist was doubting him,
他还是欣赏施洗约翰
And yet, He admires and he confirmed John the Baptist.
那他就肯定施洗约翰的怀疑当中，他给他肯定说，你说的那一位就是。
And in that doubt, he confirmed that I am the one.
所以我们这个一代一代当中，我们每一代的人怎么传承呢
？So from generation to the next generation, how are we going to sustain and pass it on?
包括我们现在有些做家族生意也一样的。
Well, including people in their family businesses.
包括我们的家里面那个长辈跟年轻一辈那种的代沟的问题，在圣经里面我们要学习的。
Including where there's generation gap between the older generation and the younger generation in family, we all need to learn from the Bible.
最近我们教会啊，有些比较年轻的牧师啊，喜欢去骑脚踏车。
Well, recently in our churches,
in Hong Kong,
our churches, some younger pastors like to go cycling.
他们跑去哪里骑脚车？他带那些年轻到台湾环岛去骑脚踏车。
Well, where do they cycle? They go around the Taiwan island.
我们说你搞什么？你牧师啊，那么去脚踏车
？We say, well, what are you doing? You're a pastor. Why are you cycling?
而且带那些年轻人去多危险啊。
Well, you bring all these young people in, isn't that dangerous?
哇，出现一个意外，我们教会怎么办啊？
Well, if there's accident, what are we going to do?
哇，你没事干啊，你啊？
Well, you got nothing better to do?
就不是查经嘛，应该是吧？
Well, you should do like Bible studies.
去带领门徒课程嘛。
Well, to do discipleship.
跑去带他们去骑脚踏车，那么危险啊。
Well, do cycling, isn't that very dangerous?
啊，我有时候也骂那些年轻的牧师啊。
So even...我也骂了，
我也骂了。
Even I scolded the young pastor.
最近呢，因为我教一个课程叫宣教学哈。
So recently I taught this course called
mission.
Mission.
Missiology, huh?
Missiology.
那有一个同学就是那个教会的，就做了一个功课。
So there's this student. He did this homework.
就讲到他们骑脚踏车的属灵经验啊。
We spoke about the spiritual experience from his cycling trip.
我说骑脚踏车还有什么属灵经验？
我说 well, what kind of spiritual experience from cycling?
我当然喜欢骑脚踏车。我在台湾读大学四年都骑脚踏车。
Well, I like cycling. I spent 4 years in Taiwan and I cycle all 4 years.
最近我在汕头大学也买了一辆脚踏车在骑哈。
Well, even in Shantou University, I also bought a bicycle to cycle there.
不过就摔下来了哈。
But I fell.
因为年纪大，那个平衡不太好。
Because I'm growing old and my sense of balance is not that good anymore.
那个同学的功课里面就告诉我们他们这个骑脚踏车的属灵经验。
So that homework that was submitted spoke about the spiritual experience from cycling.
讲到这些愿意去的，当有些还没有信主的年轻人也愿意哦，教会办这个很好，我也参加。
And spoke about well, there are many even non-believers came to church because.The church organized the trip.
原来是危险的嘛。
Well, but it's dangerous.
他们要凭着要信心呢。
But they have faith.
他们要彼此怎么照顾，怎么去爱的。
They need to learn how to take care of one another to love.
他们有一个盼望，知道要他们要到终点去。
Well, they have a hope. They want to get to the destination.
每天晚上他们要分享的。
Every night, they're sharing.
每天晚上就将他们信望爱。在他们生命的当中每天的过程里面去分享
Every night they share about the faith, love and hope through their experience of the day
也分享他们以前生命当中不同的故事
And they also share about their own personal journeys
有些年轻人就经过这个骑脚踏车以后他们信主了
Well, there are some young people they accepted Christ through this cycling experience
我们今天以为还是、哦、年轻人嘛就带他们跳跳土风舞啊等等哈就会吸引他们来的啦哈。
Well, we all think that well, the young people you just do some folk dance, and you can bring the young people in.
因为我们那个时候是这样的哈。
Because that's what happened during my generation.
才想起，原来那个时候跳土风舞，那些老人家也骂我们的嘛。
Well, then I remember that even when we did the folk dance, the old people then they scolded us too.
怎么在教会里面跳土风舞啊
？Well, how can you dance in the church?
一代一代是不一样的。
Every generation is different.
我们看不顺眼。
Well, it's not pleasing to our views.
但是其实上帝就是用不同的时代、不同的人、不同的经验去认识耶稣。
But God is going to use different people at different generations with different experience to bring people to Him.
耶稣道成的肉身
，Jesus became flesh，
住在人的当中
，and He lives among the people，
充充满满的有恩典、有真理
，and is full。Of grace and truth.
所以我们这个就是我们的标准。
And that's the standard that we.
上帝在时代当中。
God at generations.
在不同的时代有不同的样子。
At different generations, there are different forms.
有不同的方法。
There are different methods.
但核心还是一样的，要道要成为肉身。
But the core to it is that the word will become flesh.
耶稣还没钉十字架，所以他叫那些鬼也不要乱讲。
So before Jesus was crucified, so he said that even the ghosts, the spirits should not talk about it.
那些门徒你不要去讲。
Well, disciples don't talk about it.
因为我还没钉十字架。
Because I'm yet to be crucified.
我们还没有从死人中复活。
I haven't been resurrected.
你不要整天就在那边讲。
So stop talking about it.
今天我们教会也一样。
Churches are like that today.
很多没有信主人就说你们教会是很会讲的。在教会里面 they're very talkative and very verbal proclamation of gospel. Use words.
就讲你们教会就很会只是用讲的。
No deeds.
就没有行为。
行动。
行动。
我们今天语言、言语跟行动必须要配合的。
Today the words and deeds must come hand in hand.
我们说耶稣2000年前钉十字架了。
We said Jesus was crucified 2000 years ago.
那些朋友说跟我有什么关系？
Well, our friend said, well, what has got to do with me?
我没有在你身上看到耶稣的十字架的记号啊。
I don't see the mark of that cross of Jesus in you.
我没有看到你愿意为了爱你的甚至仇敌或者爱你的邻舍而愿意牺牲自己啊。
I don't see that you are ready to sacrifice yourself because you love your neighbor or you love your enemies.
我们有没有耶稣基督的十字架的记号？
Do we have the mark of the cross of Christ with us?
我们有没有复生命复活的盼望？
Do we have the hope of resurrection?
所以我们不怕吃亏。
So therefore, we are okay to be taken advantage of.
我们不怕人家的误会。
So we are not afraid to be misunderstood.
最重要的是我们不怕死。
Even most importantly is that we are not afraid to die.
耶稣已从死人中复活了。
Well, Jesus is resurrected from death.
你还怕什么？
What are we afraid of?
耶稣说了，你赚了全世界，赔上你的生命有什么好处呢？
Jesus said that even if you can win the whole world and you give up your life, what good does it have?
你的生命怎么看你的价值呢？
Well, how you, 你的生命怎么？
怎么 you value your own life?
How do you value your own life?
你为什么而活？
What are you living for?
是为了完成吗？
Is it for cari makan?
是为了生存吗？
Is it for survival only?
像猫跟狗一样吗？
Just like the cats and dogs.
还是你为了更高的意义呢？
Is it for higher values?
是你的生命能够祝福其他人的生命呢？
Is it for your life to be blessings for others?
你的生命为了别人的好处呢？
Is it for others?
令他的生命更丰盛呢？
So that their lives become more abundant.
你的生命能够赚多一个生命跟从主吗？
Can your life bring another life to follow God?
那你的生命就赚了。
Then your life is a profitable life.
Again,
your life is a gain.
只要赚两个，就更赚的更多了。
Well, if you win two, then it's double, it's even more.
所以，我们今天我们看到耶稣，他在他的时代道成肉身。
So we see Jesus in his generation, he became flesh.
他有限制的。
There's limitation.
他是一个犹太人。
He's a Jew.
他只能够活在2000年前。
He could only live in 2000 years ago.
他不能同时在耶路撒冷又在加利利。
He can't be in Jerusalem and at Galilee at the same time.
更不能来到中国。
And even more so, he can't come to China.
但是这2000年
，But this 2000 years,
他就影响那么多的生命。
He influenced so many lives.
一代一代的去见证这个道成肉身的福音。
Generations to generations to testify.The gospel of word becoming flesh.
So, 我今天早上又回到 City One.
So this morning I went to City One again.
再仔细去看他们的那个 City One 的历史。
I look at the history of City One.
480几人下船来 City One.
There are more than 400 old people alighted from a boat to get to City One.
但是只有300多人到达 City One.
But there are only 300.That made it.
有三个牧师陪着他们来的。
There were three pastors that came with them.
在船上已经死了一些人了。
Well, there were some people that died on the boat.
有些人就逃跑了。
Or some people fled.
但是就是那300多人就开始整个 City One 的这个垦场。
But these 300 people, they started City One.
那三个牧师里面有一个是外国人，两个是 华人。
Among them, the three pastors, one is a foreigner, two are Chinese.
有一个医生陪着他们坐那条船。
Together with them, there was a doctor.
那些人为什么要这样做？
So why did they do this?
那几个人不需要陪他们的。
Well, these people, they don't have to accompany them.
他们愿意。
But they're willing.
他们不怕死。
They're not afraid to die.
当年很多的传教士来中国，来马来西亚，他们就是不怕死。
Well, there were a lot of missionaries that came to China, they came to Malaysia. They were not afraid of death.
福音就展开了。
That's how gospel started.
多少的生命就改变了。
So many lives were changed.
其实我们今天要讲第二个是保罗与提摩太。
The second characters, second set of characters is Paul and Timothy.
听说早上呢，何牧师已经讲过了。
I heard that Reverend Ho spoke about that this morning.
So I 就不需要多讲了。
So I don't have to speak about it much.
但是还要稍微讲一点。
But I'll just talk about it slightly.
因为保罗常常都这样，我稍微讲一讲。
Because Paul always says, I'll just talk about it slightly.
保罗常常说，你们要效法我。
Paul always says that imitate me.
因为我效法基督。
Because I imitate Christ.
而保罗有那么多的保罗的书信。我只觉得有一句话，我觉得是他的生命的最有代表性的那一句话。
Paul had many epistles, but I believe that there's this one line that truly represents his life.
For me, yeah.
For me.
That is in the very important book, researched by our president.
那在我们的会长所研究的那一本书里面就有了，
就是加拉太书哈。
That's in the book of Galatians.
会长应该是哪一节？
A precedent, which verse should it be?
啊，对我来讲呢，讲呢是他研究那一章啊，不过就是24-29节，加拉太书三章啊，24-29节。
For me is Galatians chapter 3, verse 26 to 29.
So 我们就一起念英语了这一次啊，刚刚念的中文哈。好，我们一起来念。这个英语啊 So in Christ Jesus, you are all children of God through faith. For all of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. If you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seed.And heirs according to the promise.
所以打中文啊，给我们啊，不要那么快跑到提摩太去了啊。中文，哎，
啊，就来了啊。要看中文的可以看。对我来讲，保罗整个生命当中最重要的。
So for me, the most important point about Paul's life.
他不只是说传福音呐。
Not only that, it was about sharing gospel.
他传福音的目的是什么呢
？But what's the purpose in that?
啊，因为他们上天堂啊。
Because they will enter heaven.
保罗书信里面完全没提的。
No, Paul did not mention about any of this in the epistles.
所以有些人懂神学说，哦，他们要我们因信称义嘛。
Well, they, he wants us to be justified through faith.
那因信称义干嘛呢？
Well, justified through faith for what?
那有哦，又得救啊，又上天堂。
Well, so that the salvation, or then you enter the heaven.
其实保罗的身份就是我是谁这个问题，对保罗来讲，他也在寻找他的身份。
So for Paul himself, his identity, he was seeking about who he is.
他在很多的书信里面强调，我是希伯来人中的希伯来人。
Well, in many of his epistles, he emphasize that he's a Hebrews of a he's
of
a Hebrew.
Hebrew. 我是亚伯拉罕的子孙，我是便雅悯支派的。
I'm an heir of Abraham. I'm from the Benjamin. I'm a Benjamite.
很强调他的犹太人的身份。
He emphasized a lot of his identity being a Jew.
甚至他迫害那时候的基督徒，我们叫他的基督徒啊，那些就是犹太人
啊，迫害他吗？
当然迫害他们呢、啊，像史提凡呢、啊，哈、yeah. huh?。
So even the people that persecuted them, they were all Jews.
因为他们竟然相信一个被钉在木头上的人是弥赛亚，是上帝的儿子。
Because they were appalled that they believed in this person that was crucified on the cross being a Messiah.
对他来讲，律法是咒诅这种人的。
For them.The law is to curse this kind of people.
竟然你们说他是基督，是上帝的儿子。
But yet you say that this is the Christ, this is the Messiah.
保罗是热心律法的。
Well, Paul, he's very familiar with the law.
因为他是个犹太人。
Because he's a Jew.
但是他在大马色路上遇到复活的基督以后。
But after he encountered with the resurrected Lord.
他生命改变了。
His life changed.
不是从相信犹太教变成相信基督教啊。
It wasn't from being a
believer of Judaism,
to become a Christian.
No, there's no Christian that identity in Pauline letters.
在这个保罗的书信是没有这个基督徒的这一个身份的。
Also knows nothing to talk about Christianity as a religion.
也没有说是这个基督教的这一个信仰。
他不是从一个宗教变成另外一个宗教。
He did not go from one religion to another religion.
他从头到尾都是一个犹太人。
From beginning to the end, he has always been a Jew.
他就相信的信仰就是犹太的信仰。
Well, the faith that he had is a faith for the Jews.
也就是我们今天所说的希伯来的圣经，旧约圣经的信仰。
Well, it's the same faith as the Bible of the Hebrews.
不过他从这个经历的复活的基督以后。
But after he experienced the resurrected God,
他确认这个他以为是律法咒诅的人，原来是上帝的儿子。
He then realized that this person that's supposed to be condemned by the law is the Son of God.
是上帝祝福的人。
Is a person that's blessed by the Lord.
所以他改变了。
So he's changed.
他将这个外邦人也同样是律法所咒诅的人。
Well, the Gentiles are the people that's condemned by the law.
而他现在会承认，原来在亚伯拉罕的应许里面，就是要祝福万族万民的。
Then he realized that in the promise for Abraham, it is to bless all nations and all tribes.
他改变了，成为一个外邦的使徒。
So he's changed to be an apostle for the Gentiles.
一个犹太人本来跟外邦人是仇敌。
A Jew and a Gentile, they were enemies.
但是保罗变成一个要将犹太人的祝福也同样要给外邦人了。
But Paul has changed so much so that he wants to bring the blessings for the Jews to these Gentiles.
所以这个保罗最重要的身份。
So that's the most important identity of Paul.
也就是保罗最重要的使命。
And the most important mission for him.
就是要将这些犹太人眼中的仇敌变成大家都是上帝的子民。
Is to bring these people that originally seen as enemies of Jews to all become the people of God.
The same as Jews.
Same as Jews.
所以这段的经文呢、啊，哎，不见了，怎么搞的？哎，回来、啊。啊，回来
，come back。
你们记得的了哈。保罗在这个加拉太书三章二十六到二十九节这里。
Paul in Galatians chapter 3:26-29。
他讲到说，在基督耶稣里面
，He says in Christ Jesus，
你不再分犹太人、希利尼人
，There's neither Jews or Greeks，
自主的为奴的
，slave nor free，
或男或女。
Male or female,
因为在基督耶稣里面都成为一了。
Because you are all one in Christ Jesus.
就像我刚才所说的，我们不需要都同意，但是我们要同心。
We don't have to have all the same opinion, but we must have all the same heart.
其实很多时候，你要以为说，哦，这是都成为一了。什么叫成为一呢？
So when he says that they all become one, what does it mean?
啊，犹太人跟外邦人怎么能够成为一呢？
Well, the Jews and the Gentiles, how can they become one?
你是犹太人，信了主还是犹太人？
You are a Jew after you accepted Christ. You are still a Jew.
我信了主，我还是一个马来西亚人。
After I accepted Christ, I'm still a Malaysian.
我还是一个华人。
I'm still a Chinese.
怎么能够唯一呢？
Well, how can we be one?
你是男的啊，我是女的。
You are male and I'm a female.
我们怎么能够成为一呢？
How can we become one?
不会信主以后就变成同去一个厕所的嘛？
Well, we can't just all enter after accepting Christ in the same toilet.
但日本可以的。
But in Japan, you can.
其实这里最重要就是那个仇恨改变了。
Here, the most important thing is that the hatred has been changed.
那个优越感改变了。
This sense of excellence, self-excellence has changed.
那种权力的关系改变了。
And this relationship about power has changed.
保罗从来没有废除这个奴隶制度的。
Well, Paul has never changed this slavery system.
他说你是主人，你继续做主人。
He says, if you are the master, you continue to be a master.
你信了主以后，你是奴隶，继续做奴隶。
After you accepted Christ, if you are a slave, continue to be a slave.
他没有改变这个社会上面的关系。
He has not changed this relationship in the society.
但他在腓利门书里面就提醒这个腓利门跟亚尼西姆。
But in the book of Philemon, he reminded the Philemon and
Onesimus.
Onesimus.
虽然你继续做主人，
Well, even though that you continue to be a master,
他继续做奴隶。
He continued to be a slave.
在社会的阶级上没有分。
There is no,
还是没有变。
Well, there's no change in the societal status.
但是他提醒腓利门说。
But he reminded Philemon.
这个亚尼西姆是我属灵的儿子。
What is Onesimus is my spiritual son.
是我所爱的。
Someone that I love.
是你的兄弟。
He's your brother.
他欠了你的债。
Well, he owes you.
但你呢又欠了我的债。
But yet you owe me.
那我呢又欠了他的债。
And I owe him.
三角债来的。
Well, this is a three-way debt.
社会的这种的阶级没变。
There's no change in societal status.
但这个内容性质关系改变了。
But the content, the characteristic, and the relationship has changed.
大家知道这句话是两千年前讲的。
Everyone, you know that this was spoken 2,000 years ago.
那个时代
，at that time,
希腊人跟犹太当时仇敌啊。
Greek and Jews, they were enemies.
主人跟奴隶当然就是这个主人看那个奴隶是货物一样没有价值的。
Master and slaves, the masters will treat the slaves just like goods. There's no value.
男当然是很尊贵的女是卑贱的。
Of course, male is more noble and the female, they are of no value.
其实到了今天
even until today,
种族的仇恨还在的。
Well, the hatred between the different
Races
continues.
所以我不敢讲太大声，因为马来西亚这个种族问题很敏感啊。
And I don't dare to speak too loudly about this because it's very sensitive here in this country.
而且种族之间那种的紧张关系，到今天还没解决呢。
And the tension between the different races, it hasn't been resolved today.
但是当然比一百年前、两百年前、两千年前已经改变很多了。
Of course, there's huge change.Compared to 100, 200,
2,000
years ago. 保罗
的福音不单是说我们要成为上帝的子民，我们要回天家。
The Gospel of Paul talks not just about that we will accept Christ and we return to the heaven.
那是今天在此时此地。
But today, here, now,
我们怎么打破这种族之间的仇恨那种的优越？
How are we going to break that hatred between the races?
怎样去打破那种的性别之间的那种的优劣。
How are we going to break the difference between the different genders?
而且那个经济上的阶级、社会阶级之间的矛盾怎么能够去打破？
And how are we going to break the conflict between the different status of the society?
这个是福音的大能。
And that's the might of the gospel.
这个就是牵涉到你每天的生活里面。
And these.Close relates to your daily lives.
而从两千年来，不同的世代有不同的人为这些而努力。
And in the past 2,000 years, there are different people in different generations working hard for these things.
大家知道，奴隶制度在美国到十九世纪才基本上根本做了改变。
The slavery system had only fundamentally changed in the 19th century in the U.S.
但在1960年代，马丁·路德·金这个黑人牧师还为的那些黑人的那个地位还在抗争。
In 1960s, Martin Luther King, this black
still fight for the right,
black, pastor,
black right,
still fight for the black rights.
我们知道这个社会的阶级的斗争，在我们的社会还在那种抗争的关系里面。
We know that this fight between the differentHierarchy of the societies continues today.
保罗明显是很刚强的人。
Clearly, Paul is a very strong person.
但是保罗也是一个很多时候他找的他的继承人提摩太其实是一个比较软弱的人。
But many times, his successor Timothy seemed to be a very weak person.
所以我们最后看看这个提摩太后书啊。
So let us look at 2 Timothy.
一章。
Chapter 1.
因为这一段好像何牧师早上讲过了哈，那我就讲下面那一段哈。
Well, the first passage was already spoken by Reverend Ho, so I'll talk about the second.
讲一章的提摩太后书啊。
太浅。Second Timothy.
刚才，哎呦，
没有打到。哎，
又不见了哈。
没有打到。
你有打到吗？刚才好像有打出来的哈。
那是提前。
啊，提前。
对。
那不要提前了，我们
要提后了吗？
我们后来才讲了哈。
对。
讲到里面，其实提摩太是个很软弱的人。
We spoke about that Timothy was a very weak person.
所以保罗不断要强调说你要刚强。
So Paul continues to remind him to be strong.
甚至用精兵。
Well, even he used being a soldier,
一个农夫
example, being a soldier, being a farmer.
怎么样去努力？
Well, how does a farmer, how do you work hard?
怎么去刚强？
How do you be strong?
奇怪，为什么保罗找一个比较软弱的人当他的这个好像是他的徒弟啊？
Well, it's strange that he finds a weaker person to be his pupil.
因为他知道最重要是神在工作。
Because he knew that the most important part is that God is at work.
神在不同的人的身上的工作。
It's God's work at different people.
说到最后呢，我讲讲我自己的故事了。
So lastly, I want to talk about my own story.
啊，因为他们说你这样讲那些马来西亚的牧师也可以讲啊。
Well, they say, well, all these things that even the Malaysian pastor can talk about.
嗯，还是讲讲我自己，你们就不能别人可以讲哈。
Well, you talk about myself, yourself, then no one else can talk about it.
啊，今天呢，很多弟兄姐妹就问我说，哎，你真的香港出生的吗
？Well, today a lot of brothers and sisters ask me, are you really born in Hong Kong?
那你怎么华语比那些香港来的人好像不太像啊
？Well, how come your Mandarin sounds very different from those that came from Hong Kong？
那有些弟兄姐妹呢，就记忆错误的，哎呀，几年前他来的时候，华语没有那么好的。
Well, some brothers and sisters say, well, a few years ago when he came, his Mandarin not as good。
而且还说啊，他上次来是用广东话讲到的。
Well, some even say that, well, the last time he came, he spoke in Cantonese。
啊，肯定你的记性是错了哈。
Well, I'm sure that your memory is bad。
为什么会讲啊？何牧师请我来就是。因为我的华语比较好啊。
Why the president and Reverend Hall invited me? Because my Mandarin is good.
香港好多牧师啊，比我讲到更好的。
Well, many pastors, they preach better than me
in Hong Kong.
In Hong Kong,
but their Mandarin is much poorer than me.
但是他们的中文就比我差很多了。
中文华语，
华语就比我差很多了。
所以他们就不来不请了。
So they are not invited.
其实呢，有些人说，哦，对对，他在刚才说嘛，他在台湾念大学的嘛。
Oh yeah, well he studied in the Taiwanese university.
不是 Taiwanese university.
In the Taiwan
university in Taiwan.
A university in Taiwan.
Not Taiwan University. Taiwan University is a university. I'm in the better university.
我就不是在台大，我比台大还好的大学。
叫中兴大学哈。其实。你看看那些侨生哈，从台湾回来的，他们的 普通话都很糟糕的。
Well, you see a lot of returnees when they come back, their Mandarin is not very good.
十八岁才学一个语言，怎么学得好啊
？Well, you only start learning a language at 18 years old. How can you be excel in it?
而且那些香港学生去台湾呢，都很骄傲的。
We see a lot of people that came from Hong Kong and went to Taiwan. They're all very proud of themselves.
我觉得台湾人呢都比他们差一点。
But they all feel that the Taiwanese are not as good.
他们的朋友都找香港的朋友。
Well, their friends are all like people from Hong Kong.
或者找些马来西亚来的侨生。
Or find some students from Malaysia.
除非他们谈恋爱。
Well, unless they are
fall in love. If a girl or a boy of Taiwan.
Fall in love with someone from Taiwan.
怎么讲讲不？
就跟这个台湾的男孩子或者女孩子谈恋爱呢？
所以他们的普通话才会这个改善。
Well, then their Mandarin's improved.
这我不是。
But I'm not.
因为我本身不是广东人。
I'm not a Cantonese.
其实我是广西人。
I'm a
广西人。
广西人。
但其实原因，我在香港是在难民营长大的。
But I grew up in a refugee camp in Hong Kong.
你说哎，香港有难民营呢
？You say, oh, there's refugee camp in Hong Kong.
当然有啊，在1949年中国政权改变的时候，几百万人从内地跑到香港来的哈。
Yes, of course. In 1949, when there's political change in China, few million people came.From China, has fled to Hong Kong.
很多人以为哦，那些都是有钱人才来的嘛。
Many people thought that those are all the rich people.
有钱人他不用跑的啊。
Rich people they don't flee.
他跑到美国去啊，跑到别的地方去。
Or they would go to America or other places.
是很多穷人来的。
Was the poor that came?
而且是我的父母亲在他们中学的时候就很爱国的。
Well, my parents, even in their secondary years, they loved the country. They were
patriotic. 他们参与一些学生运动的。
They were in the students' movements.
所以我父母是在战场里面认识的。
So my parents, they know each other at the battlefield.
他们都是当军人。
They were all soldiers.
我爸爸也是蒋介石的一个警官学校的学生。
My father, he was Jiang Jieshi's a student in Jiang Jieshi's military school.
Not military, police.
A police school.
So, 我们跑到香港，我才出生。
So, I was born when they fled to Hong Kong.
我是全家唯一在香港出生的人。
I was the only person that was born in Hong Kong in my family.
那时候我们很穷，就住在一个难民营里面。
We were really poor and we lived in a refugee camp.
那个难民营不是香港政府难民营，但是那个难民是台湾政府派人来管理的。
Well, this refugee camp is not by the Hong Kong government. It was started by a Taiwanese government.
所以我们在那个幼稚园、小学、中学都是讲华语的。
So,My kindergarten, my primary school, my secondary school, I spoke Mandarin.
不是我，是那里边学校啊。
The school spoke Mandarin.
但我从小学一年级以后，我就到市区里面生活了。
But started from year one, I moved to the city.
不过我的幼稚园跟我小学一年级就是用普通话来学的。
My kindergarten and my year one, I studied in Mandarin.
而且我来我家的那些朋友呢？都很少讲广东话的。
So, and the friends that come to my house, rarely they speak Cantonese.
So, 我这个人是很异类的一个人。
So, I'm quite different.
我是香港出生，又不是跟香港人一起生活的。
I'm born in Hong Kong. I was born in Hong Kong, and yet I don't really live with the Hong Kong people.
我从小就对中国的政治、历史、文化有很多的那个机会去学习。
And from young, I had many opportunities to learn about the culture, the history, and the politics of China.
因为来我家跟我父亲、母亲谈的东西，不是讲这个电影明星啊，或者是啊一些其他的新闻的哈。
Because people that come to my family to discuss with my parents, they didn't talk about the movie stars or things like that.
都是讲到整个中国的苦难啊，中国的文化、中国的历史啊，中国的政治。
They talk about the politics, the suffering, the culture, the history of China.
但我父亲对国民党很失望，所以他一生都不愿意去台湾。
So my father was disappointed with 国民党 so he didn't want to go to Taiwan.
但是我呢，因为呢是最小的孩子
，But because I was the youngest.
很穷的时候，我还有机会去念大学。
Even though we were really poor, I had the opportunity to go to university.
我虽然是念一个英文的中学，但我结果是跑到台湾去念大学了。
Well, I went into an English.Secondary school, and yet I ended up doing my university in Taiwan.
那我家里呢，让我很喜欢念书，但是不懂得怎么考试。
Well, I love to read, but I'm not good at exam.
所以考试成绩都比较糟糕。
So my exam results were really bad.
所以我在那个叫做Form 6的时候是不能升上这个 Form 7的哈。
So in my sixth form, I can't go into the seventh.
因为我的成绩的什么都不及格。
Because I failed in many areas.
那上帝恩典。
But God's grace.
那竟然给我考到台湾去念大学去。
But he allowed me to enter into university in Taiwan.
那个大学最重要的是农学院。
Well, in that university, the most important faculty is agricultural.
而我当时呢，因为我父亲说不是政治救国了。
My father then said it's not through.Politics that we can save the country.
中国是农业国家
says China is an agricultural-based country.
所以农业救国
Well, we're going to save the country by agriculture.
所以虽然香港好像没有什么农业
So even though that there's not much of such agricultural activities in Hong Kong,
但我就去念农业
But when
学院
I studied agriculture,
是 forestry,
forestry, 森林学
啊，厉害哈，还知道森林学哈。
Forestry.
So, 我很喜欢这个甘博啊，那边有森林啊。
So I like Gampa because there's like forest.
啊，我喜欢去西部啊。
I like Cebu.
啊 ，Kapit 啊。
Kapit.
啊，那边很多森林啊。
There's a lot of jungles.
而且呢，那里有很多的牧养的机会啊。
牧养 ，pastor.
Yeah.
There are a lot of opportunity to pastor.
所以我过去这一年去了两次 Carpet 的那个森林了哈。
So in the past year, I've been to Carpet's jungles twice.
我去想去牧养那边的牧山的工人哈。
I want to go and pastor the people that work in the sawmill.
很可惜那边很少华人了现在哈。
But unfortunately, there are not that many Chinese there.
但我又不懂马来话哈。
And I don't know my Bahasa.
结果呢，那个陪我去那个。年轻的牧者也不懂马来话，我很奇怪。
Well, the young pastor that comes in, accompanies me also doesn't know his Bahasa.
东马联谊会的哈。
Was from the Borneo.
不是 Borneo, Sarawak.
Sarawak Annual Conference.
对对对，所以呢，而且那边都是越来越少华人了。
And they are less and less, getting less and less Chinese.
因为我当年念这个时候，我就希望做一个 missionary。
So when I studied, I wanted to be a missionary, 宣教士。
啊，就是哈。而且因为呢，我本来想学医学院的，但是我发现我对动物没有什么兴趣。
Well, I wanted to be
a medical doctor.
I wanted to be a medical doctor, but I'm not interested in living things.
No,
animals.
Living things very interesting.
这个生物是很有
我每一次学解剖啊，就是那个神经线都给我割掉了。
Every time I do
anatomy,
I'll always cut the nerves.
So I was thinking, 哎呀，植物才很有趣啊。
So I think, well, plants are very interesting.
哇，在显微镜底下，哇，那些叶子啊，那些细胞啊，哇，美得不得了。
Well, under the microscope, the leaves, the cells are all beautiful.
我想起以前那些很伟大的传教士，像那个 Livingstone 啊、李文斯顿、史怀哲，他们到森林里面去当医生的传教士。
So I was thinking that Livingstone, Schweizer, they all went into the forest, the jungles to be a missionary, to be a doctor.
所以我念不了这个医学，我就念森林嘛。
So if I can't can't do a medic, then I'll go into forestry.
所以我能够去森林里面传教。
Then I'll preach in the jungle.
所以我那个时候就开始立志要做一个传教士。
So then I made up my mind to be a missionary.
但是呢，当我要大学里面的时候呢，我慢慢呢就发现呢，原来呢我们的教会很需要牧师。
Then in my university years, then I realized that churches need a lot of pastors.
今天有位姐妹问我，哎，你认不认识这个李炳光牧师啊？
Well, today a sister asked me if I know this pastor 李炳光牧师。
我说我当然认识，我认识他五十五年了。
Of course, I know him. Know him for 55 years.
因为我初一的时候，他刚刚神学毕业。
Because when I was
Form one,
he just graduated from seminary.
So 他是我的牧师，是五十五年前了哈。
Well, he was my pastor 55 years ago.
但是在这十三年里面，我们没有另外一个牧师哈。
在十三年吗？嗯。But 13 years in between, we didn't have another pastor.
So 我发现我毕业的时候，上帝好像呼召我要回到我的教会去当牧养。
So after I graduated, God called me to be a pastor in my church.
那时候我就是发现。好，我当我呢有另外的人兴起要去念神学的时候，我就会去森林去了。
So I thought to myself, I said, well, until someone is called and rise up to be a pastor, then I will go into my forest, the jungles.
但是呢，我从1976年神学毕业当牧师，到了我退休的时候啊，这个当了这个2014年，我都在这个三合土的森林里面。
Well, between 1976until 2014, until I graduated, I was in the concrete jungle.
所以我才要去跑到西部去。
That's why I'm now going to Cebu.
但是我发现上帝的带领就是那么奇妙。
But you realize that God's leading is such miraculous.
我想去森林那边当传教士，结果在这个三合土森林里面当传教士。
I wanted to be a missionary in the jungle. I ended up to be a missionary in the concrete jungle.
但是这三十多年在这个三合土的森林里面，我看见上帝在工作。
But in the past 30 over years, I see God's work in this concrete jungle.
我这个从难民营本来长大的，又跑去台湾念什么森林系的人，竟然在香港的社会，在我们的大学里面能够侍奉上帝。
While growing up in a refugee camp, in Hong Kong, I ended up studying in Taiwan, and ended up serving.In the concrete jungle in Hong Kong.
因为从我开始要寻找上帝的呼召的时候开始。
Because it started off when I was searching for God's calling.
我在大学的时候常常都是用个人布道哈。
Well, during my university, I always do personal testimony.
啊，这个你们在这里也有这个 campus crusade 嘛？啊， yeah. 学院传道会啊。
You have campus crusade here too.
啊，四律啊，去传福音。
Well, the four spiritual law use that to share gospel.
但慢慢我就发现，上帝不只是个人的上帝。
I didn't realize that God is not just a personal God.
上帝是关心我们整个国家、民族、社会的。
God also takes care. He's also concerned.With the country and the tribes and the society.
因为从上帝呼召亚伯拉罕开始，就不是呼召他一个人。
Because when God called Abraham from the very beginning, it's not just calling himself.
乃是呼召他整个民族。
He called his entire tribe.
而整个民族要祝福的，不只是个人，要祝福万民万族的。
And this tribe, is not just to bless their own, but to bless.The nations and the other tribes.
保罗的福音不只是要拯救一个一个的人的。
The Pauline gospel is not to just save one by one.
乃是要拯救这个犹太人跟希腊人这个外邦人不同的族群怎么能够和好。
But it's to save the Jews and the Greek and the Gentiles and for them to reconcile.
怎么令到这些主人跟奴隶之间不再是仇敌，乃是能够互相彼此相爱的。
And it is about how to enable the master and the slave to no longer be enemies, but to love one another.
上帝呢，不只是数每一个人的头发的哈。有人都说上帝很爱我们，连你的头发都算过。
Well, God is not just a God that counts how many hairs you have.
那我的就很容易算的哈。
Well, mine is easy to count.
上帝要关心整个人的生命的价值。
God is concerned with the value of human's life.
上帝要看公义有没有在我们的社会、我们的国家里面表现出来。
God wants to see whether justice is manifested in our society.
所以在我念神学的时候，无论是看圣经，无论是看教会历史，我们看到这个上帝是很伟大的上帝。
Well, so when I was studying theology, no matter if you are looking at Bible.Or the church history, we can see that God is a great God.
我们是怎样去牧养的？不只是一个一个的信徒。
How are we going to pastor? Is when we pastor, it's not just about individual believers.
我们要牧养的这个群体是教会。
But we are to pastor church as a community.
而我们整个教会要牧养这个世界。
And the church is to pastor this world.
所以约翰卫斯理就说了。
So.John Wesley said this.
整个世界是我们的牧区。
The world is our parish.
不只是在 PJ.
Not just PJ.
是整个马来西亚都是上帝要牧养的。
The entire Malaysia is where God wants us to pastor.
当然我们的美加堂在 PJ 也要牧养整个 PJ 这个社区的。
Of course, MegaCMC, we also need to pastor PJ as a community.
So, 当我在1976年开始当牧师的时候
So, when I became a pastor in 1976,
在整个九龙的这个很中心的市区叫油麻地
I went to this place in Kowloon called 油麻地
啊啊，你去过哈？
啊，去过。嗯，
我们的教堂很大的哈。
Our church is big.
是一个独立的建筑物，可以坐1000人的礼堂。
It's a structure on its own.It has a hall for 1,000 people.
我们有一个中学很有名的。
We have a very famous secondary school.
也很有名的幼小学也在旁边。
We also have a very famous primary school.
那个时候还有一个幼稚园。
We also had a kindergarten.
哇，很多人很想进到这个学校。
But a lot of people they want to enter these schools.
当我在这个礼拜堂当一个助理牧师的时候
，When I was a assistant pastor in this church,
我每天就在想
，I always thought to myself,
啊，这个教堂呢，我们会有觉得很骄傲啊。
Well, this church, our members, they must be really proud.
哇，你看，我们有好的中学、好的小学、美丽的礼拜堂。
You see, we've got a good secondary school, primary school, a beautiful church building.
哇，在市中心。
Well, in the city center.
那么贵的一个土地上，我们建立了那么大的一个漂亮的礼拜堂。
On such an expensive land, we built such a beautiful building.
但我想说，假如是那些没有信主人会怎么想呢
？Well, I was thinking to myself, what about those unbelievers, non-believers? What would they think?
尤其油麻地呢，在尼敦道呢是比较漂亮的啊，有钱的。
And at Yaumate, this Nathan Road is a place for the affluent.
但是后面很多穷人在后面。
But there were a lot of poor people behind.
有些人就住在那个天台上面的木房子。
Some they just lived on the building top.
很小、很窄、很热的地方。
Very small, tiny, hot places.
那么想着这个礼拜堂干嘛的？
Then you're thinking, well, what's the church for?
那个小学、中学，大家的孩子都想进去。
Well, and this secondary school, this primary school, everyone wants to go in.
但那个礼拜堂
，But that church, church building.
一个礼拜七天，只有一天是很多人在那里。
Well, the church building, 7 days, there's only one day that's filled with people.
其他五天多都没有人在那里的。
Well, 5 days and more, there are not that many people.
都是放凳子的哈。
Well, it's to store benches.
说是好像是放凳子的货仓来的哈。
Well, it feels like it's a warehouse for benches.
应该给它拆掉才对。
Well, we should have just destructed it.
应该去盖房子给我们住才好。
And build houses for people to live in.
究竟教会在那个社区里面，我们自己看是这样子，哎呀，很威风。但是人家看你干嘛呢？这个跟我有什么关系
？Well, for us in that community, we felt that well, this church is really good. But for others, they were thinking, what's the church for?
Waste the piece of land.
这是浪费土地吧？
所以那个时候就想，教会究竟在这个社会里面，我们要做什么见证呢
？So I was thinking, what testimony is the church going to do?
很重要，你是为什么东西而存在的
？What are we here for?
你是浪费地图
？We're here to waste the land.
还是我们是存在那里是为了其他的人而存在的呢
？But will we exist?There for the others.
所以当然我那个是一个小牧师哈。
Of course, I was just a small pastor then.
我在那里没有什么话语权呢哈。
Well, I don't have much right to speak.
所以还好，卫理公会有派司的嘛哈。
Well, good thing is that there is assignment.
Stationing.
A stationing, a sending of different pastors.
In the Methodist system.
In the Methodist system.
That's a good thing.
这是个好事。
所以呢，我就要求派到一个穷人的地区。
So I asked to be sent to a poor area.
那个叫柴湾。
This place is called 柴湾。
柴就是砍柴的柴。
Well, 柴 means woods.
那你听起来就知道什么地方叫柴湾的，是砍柴的地方。
Well, so from hearing of it, it's a place where you chop the wood.
那个是香港岛最东边的一个很贫穷的社区。
Is a very poor area in the easternmost side of Hong Kong.
那边呢最有名是。坟场
well,
cemetery
it's very popular, famous about the cemetery
还有就是工厂
well, and factories
没有私人的住宅的
there's no housing
是那些木屋的房子啦
there are some
squatter areas cottage areas 还有就是那些政府建的叫祖屋吗你们这里啊但是不是新加坡那么漂亮的祖屋啊是穷人住的地方。
So there are only public housings and squatter areas.
所以我就要求教会派我到那里去。
So I asked the church to send me there.
其实那时候呢有一个另外一个比较年长的牧师跟我竞争的哈。
Well, back then there was a very senior pastor was competing with me.
其实不是他想去。
Well, actually he didn't want to go.
但是因为那些牧师啊，那些常务委员就说：“哎呀，那个地区找个小孩子去啊，有可能做不来的啊。”
Well, so the committee said, "Well, if that area, if you just send a young pastor, he probably can't handle the area."
应该找一个年纪大有经验的去啊。
Well, should send an experienced pastor then.
那好在呢，我之前 lobby 了一些人哈。
Well, good thing that I've lobbied a few people.
就一票之差就派我去了。
Well, just by a close vote of one vote, I was sent.
而且后来呀，我们会长也去我那里实习啊，他没讲刚才。
Well, then President Reverend Kwok also went there as practical.
A placement.
A placement.
那个地区是叫红番区哈。
Well, that place is called the Red Indian Zone.
Oh yeah, you're very good translation. 是野蛮人的地方来的。
It's a barbaric place.
但是很感谢主。
But praise the Lord.
因为圣经讲到耶稣旧约的圣经就上帝是要跟贫寒的人在一起的。
Because in the Bible, it talks about God, he wants to be with the poor.
福音要传给贫穷的人。
Gospel is to be shared with the poor people.
那时候在香港学生当中大概有20%是基督徒。
Well, in Hong Kong back then, about 20% of the students were Christians.
因为一半的学校都是教会办的。
Because half of the schools were started by churches.
但在工人劳动工人当中，不到1%是基督徒。
But among the labor force, less than 1% are Christians.
为什么会这样？
Why?
我自己就看到说，圣经里面教导很清楚。
I look at that and I say the Bible's teaching is very clear.
我也看到为什么共产党当年能够夺得政权呢？
And I saw that why the communists were able to get the right of administration.
Wow,
the government, the regime.
是因为他就是要跟那些贫穷人在一起。
Because they wanted to be with the poor.
而我们今天的教会都是中产的教会，香港也是一样。
But the churches today, even in Hong Kong, is with the middle class.
那些大学生他们不懂得怎么去服侍贫穷人那些工人。
Those university students, they don't know how to serve the poor people.
感谢主，因为我以前在难民营长大的。
But praise the Lord, because I grew up in the refugee camp.
我也在那些穷人的地区居住的。
And I used to live in a poor squatter area.
虽然我的父亲曾经当过一些蛮高的官。
Even though my father used to be quite high-ranking officer,
但是他还是一个很谦卑的人。
And yet he was a very humble person.
所以我们整个的生命当中，我就经验到圣经里面所说的，我们怎样将福音要传给贫穷的人。
So our lives, we experience truly how we must share the gospel with the poor.
难道只是用口头跟他说啊，耶稣爱你啊
？Well, is it just by saying the word that Jesus loves you?
他看到你用行动来看他了吗？爱他了吗
？Do they see that you love them by your action?
我有一个很一个经验哈。
I have this experience.
就是当我开这个洗礼班的时候啊。
When I started the baptism class.
我都会问他们说，为什么你们要洗礼啊
？I said, well, why do you want to be baptized?
其中有一个女的，当工人的女工就说了，我本来很讨厌基督徒的。
Well, there's this lady labor. She said, well, I used to hate Christian.
哎，我说你那么讨厌的，为什么你也来参加呢
？Well, if you hated Christians so much, why do you come?
哦，那现在不讨厌了。
Well, no longer hate them.
我说为什么呢
？I said why?
他说我们以前当工人的时候啊。
Said when we were hard laborers.
不是以前的，他说他们当工人的时候啊。
She said when they were laborers.
在香港那个时候是70年代、80年代，都是不是每个月有薪水的
？Well, in the 70s and 80s, they don't really get wages every month.
他们是算他们做了多少这个成品啊，来算他们的薪水的。
The wages is counted, based on the produce that they have.
但是不是很多时候那个订单是足够的啊？
足够吗？
不够
啊，不够。So, but then a lot of order were insufficient.
那些工人要去抢东西来做。
And they had to fight to get some work to do.
他说那工厂里面有些基督徒啊。
Well, in that factory, there were some Christians.
哇，他平常呢吃饭的时候要我们欢迎我们去唱诗啊。
During meal time, they would welcome us, invite us to go and sing hymns.
告诉我们说啊，耶稣爱你。
Oh, Jesus loves you.
我也爱你。
Well, I love you too.
啊，讲得很好听的哈。
Well, sounds really good.
啊，一不够工作做的时候，他们就一起去抢东西做了。
When there's not enough work, then they would just fight for those work.As well,
都不够那些基督徒抢啊
Well, we can't even win over these Christians.
因为他们整个团体去抢的嘛
Because they went as a fellowship.
哇，平常你说你爱我哈
Well, you said you love me in the usual days.
不够工作的时候你就抢东西做了哈
When there's not enough work, then you just grab them.
很讨厌
Well, I hated them.
但后来换了另外一个工厂
Then I changed a different factory.
也有些基督徒们唱诗，又说耶稣爱你。
Well, again, there's some Christian. They say, well, they sing songs. They say Jesus loves you.
当了不够工作的时候，又要去抢了。
When not enough work, they were fighting for it.
但这一次那些基督徒不太一样。
But this time the Christians different.
那些基督徒出来讲，我们不要抢。
The Christian said, oh, let's not fight.
我们来分工东西来做。
Well, let's distribute.
我们知道我们当中有些工友，他家里需要更多的。
We know that some of them they had more needs at their home.
我们分多一点给他。
Let's give them more.
他说我看到耶稣了。
He said I can see Jesus.
我看到耶稣的爱是有血有肉的。
I can see this real love of Jesus.
而不是讲的。
It's not just talking only.
所以他说我受感动了。
Say, I'm touched.
我愿意去认识耶稣了。
I'm willing to learn to know about Jesus.
说他后来愿意洗礼了。
So eventually then she was willing to be baptized.
但我在这些人当中服务的当中。
So as I serve these people.
我当然就看到所谓的什么劳工的法律啊等等都不是真正保护工人的。
I saw these laws for the laborers. They are not really protecting the laborers.
所以我看到在那个时候我就用社会行动的方法来去对这个社会里面一些无论是劳工的法律
so,
或者是一些社会公共汽车加价的课题
So then I look at this and I use the ways of civil society to address the rights of the laborers or the increase of transportation fares
因为受害的就是这些穷人
becauseThe people that were oppressed were these poor people.
他们没有这种的资源。
Well, they didn't have these resources.
他们没有途径去表达他们意见。
They have no channels to express their opinion.
他们没有地方能够聚集在讨论他们的事情。
They have no place to gather to discuss their matters.
所以我们就开放我们的礼拜堂。
So we open up our church.
他们就来这里。
Then they come.
不是来听布道会。
Well, it's not here for evangelism meeting.
他们呢讨论他们的困难，他们的问题。
But they came to discuss their problems.
他发现怎么牧师也关心他们这些事啊
？They were like, "Wow, why did the pastor show concern on these?"
上就牧师不只关心我们灵魂得救的吗
？Well, isn't it pastor should just be concerned about whether our spiritual life?
只关不关心我信耶稣的吗
？Or concerned about whether I believe in Jesus?
怎么关心我的生活
？How come he cares about my life?
关心我的生活里面的困难
？Cares about the difficulties of my life?
关心我在这个社会里面很多不公道的法律
and,
怎么去迫害我
？And care about this injustice in the law, in the legal system that is detrimental to my life?
说政府那个时候香港政府很厉害的哈。
So the Hong Kong government they were really good.
就立刻要我去当议员了。
They wanted me to be a senator.A parliamentarian.
No, not parliament, no parliament in Hong Kong, you know, there's district board. 那个地区的议会。
Oh, in a
就市议会这样子了。
Well, to serve as a district councillor.
我说对不起，我不是要当这些。
I said, that's not what I want to be.
我是要当牧师的。
I'm going to be a pastor.
你别以为我因为做这些事是为了要当议员。
Don't think that I'm doing all this because I want to be a councillor.
那今天还有人知道我这个事情，因为他们政府已经公布那个我的名单。但是我后来没有当这个议员了。
Well, some people knew this because the government has published my name on the list, and yet I did not take up the position.
因为我是为了信仰
，because of my faith.
是因为我在圣经里面的教导，我要怎么服侍那些穷人
？Because of the teaching of the Bible about how I should serve the poor.
我在那个社区又做了七年的。
So in that community, I served for 7 years.
所以有些人说我不像一个牧师。
So some people say that I don't look like a pastor.
说我是街头斗士。
Or say that I'm like a street fighter.
礼拜天怎么没有在礼拜堂？礼拜天跑到这个维多利亚公园里面搞这个群众这个活动去了。
Well, on Sunday I'm not in church. I'm in the Victoria Park and to gather people for movements, people's movements.
其实是礼拜天下午。
Actually, that's Sunday afternoon.
啊，上午做完礼拜才去的。
Well, after the Sunday service, then I went.
但是很多基督徒、很多牧师还是觉得你搞什么？你应该在礼拜堂里面的嘛。
So a lot of Christian and pastors say, "What are you doing? You should be in a church."
牧师只在那个四个墙壁的礼拜堂里面的吗
？Well, a pastor should be within the four walls of a church.
教会不是应该活在人的当中的吗？
Well, shouldn't church live among the people?
耶稣不是说道成肉身住在人的当中的吗
？Didn't Jesus became flesh?
才有血有肉的去彰显恩典与真理的吗
？It's blood and flesh to magnify the truth.
但是九年以后我就去念博士了。
So after a year of nine years serving
in the local church.
After serving 9 years.
Two years plus 7 years. So 9 years.
I served in that place for 9 years. Then I went for my doctoral.
那些人都不相信。
So those people didn't believe.
问你，你不是搞社会活动的吗？怎么去念书的
？Well, I thought you are there for the civil society. How come you went to school again?
Not to school, huh? To university.
Went to university.
他们以为我去念政治学、社会学的哈。
Well, they thought I'm going to do a political science.
但我是念最传统的圣经研究的。
But I went for the most traditional biblical research.
我是去研究这个保罗书信跟罗马书的。
And went to research Paul's letter, the Pauline,
and the letter to
the Romans.
我念完博士，当时其实教会说你别念博士啊。
After I finished my PhD, the church said,
"Well, 还没有 finish 的时候，他说你不需要念博士。
Well, before I finished my PhD, they said, "Well, don't do your PhD."
因为教会需要你回来当牧师。
Because the church needs you to be a pastor.
本来只给我两年去念的，怎么念博士啊
？Well, they only gave me 2 years. How can I do my PhD?
后来很辛苦，他说好了，给多一年你哈 ，no pay leave 啊。
They said, "Well, I'll give you 1 more year, no pay leave." 这个无薪假期。
你这个念不念完你要回来，我们需要牧师，不需要学者。
Well.Whether you finish or not, you're going to come back. We need a pastor, not a scholar.
So, 我三年就瞎着眼就交了那个博士论文。
So, in 3 years, I just closed my eyes and I just sent in my PhD thesis.
然后就不及格了。
But then I failed.
然后我的老师，其实他说很有名的老师，也是我们会长的老师。
Well, the teacher is actually also the president's teacher.
他说不行，你要抗议。
He said, "Well, this is no good. You got to protest.
你要去上诉 appeal.
You need to appeal."
结果我说我当牧师不需要博士啊。
I said,、oh, "I'm going to be a pastor. I don't need a PhD."
但是我老师说不行，你知道吗？九七以后，你有博士跟没有博士是不一样的。
But my teacher said, "Well, after 97, there's a big difference whether you have a PhD or not."
你知道九七是什么事哈
？You know what happened in 1997?
奇怪，我老师也没来过香港，也没来过中国，他怎么知道觉得不一样
？Well, my teacher has not been to Hong Kong. How come he knew it's going to be different?
啊，后来我知道了。
Then I knew.
我没有拿那个博士，我就不会去当什么院长的嘛。
Well, without my PhD, I wouldn't become the principal of a seminary.
我说我不需要了，我当牧师不需要博士的。
I said, I don't need it. I'm a pastor.
他说不行，你一定要去上诉。
No, you must have it. You must appeal.
结果我上诉了三年。
So I appealed for 3 years.
我写论文也只用了三年。
It took me 3 years to write my thesis.
结果呢，上帝很奇妙恩典，我竟然拿到博士了。
Well, so by the grace of God, I got my PhD.
所以我的 supervisor 就说，你说，哎，你看，我说你行就行，他们说不行，没用，我说行就行。
See, my supervisor said, well, I said, you can.
结果呢，会长啊，当时还参加我那个吃饭的那个。庆祝的晚宴、
So then President Reverend God came for the celebratory dinner then.
上帝很奇妙。
God is wonderful.
在人的眼中我是个难民营长大的孩子。
Well, in the eyes of people, I'm just a child that grew up in a refugee camp.
我小学一年级考第一名的。
Well, year one, I got number one.
但考到这个 Form 6呢我全部都不及格了。
Well, in Form 6, I failed all of them.
这个世界又怎么样呢
Well,How about the world?
上帝的恩典跟上帝的呼召
God's grace and God's calling.
最重要是你要看到听到上帝的呼召
Well, you need to see and you need to hear God's calling.
你要看到圣经里面讲的是什么东西你怎么行出来
You need to see what the Bible says and how do you live it out.
在不同的世代
In different generations,
无论从摩西到保罗到提摩太
From Moses to Paul to Timothy,
上帝不是看他有多少人间看到的成就上帝不看
God doesn't see how much achievement that you have in this world.
上帝看你是不是一个愿意顺服他的呼召跟带领的仆人
But God sees whether you are a servant that's willing to listen to his calling.
所以有时候我学保罗说，我稍微夸口一下
So I'm going to learn like what Paul said. I'm going to boast slightly.
我今天还是一个不错的地位的
I'm in.A not bad position today.
因为我最近又找到了新的工作。
Because recently I found a new job.
是香港基督教协进会的总干事啊。
I'm the
General Secretary,
General
Christian Council.
Hong Kong Mission Council.
不是 Mission, Christian.
A Christian Council.
我们这个是政府对口的一个单位哈。
对口。
Is the government recognized we represent the Hong Kong Christian?
It's a government recognized body.
So, 我刚刚接到我要去这个去北京庆祝国庆，他也邀请我去的。
Well, even the National Day in Beijing's celebration, they invited me.
这个香港政府的特首，他也要邀请我去参加香港那个 国庆的酒会哈。
Even the Hong Kong chief, he would invite me to a government event.
我们是个街头斗士来的嘛哈。
Oh, I was a street fighter.
从二十年前那个港独到今天这个特首都认识我的。
Well, from 20 years ago, the governor of Hong Kong, and to today,
可能是30 years ago
了。30 years ago, to the chief
governor,
minister,
to the chief governor, executive,
the chief executive, they all know me.
我是蛮有地位的哈。
I'm of certain status.
那又怎么样啊
？So what?
我只看到我希望能够成为一个上帝的仆人。
I only hope that I see that I can be a servant of God.
人的看人的重不重视这个不重要。
Whether we are seen as important in humans' eyes is not important.
所以我们今天这个不同的时代，不同的世代，上帝在工作。
So in different generations, in different era, we can see the work of God.
上帝要用一些很厉害的人，很聪明的人，考试很好的人。
God wants to use those great intelligent people that are very good in the exam.
上帝也用一些很普通的人，
and God will use ordinary people that are not very good with their exams.
无论是在你的家庭里面，你在这个学校里面，在教会里面，在整个社会里面，
no matter in your school, in your family, in the society,
你要看到上帝在工作。
You want to see God is at work.
五月九号很肯定是上帝的工作。
509 clearly is the work of God.
但你不是一个旁观者。
But you are not just a bystander.
你假如支持这个改变的话，
If you support this change,
你作为一个基督徒，
You as a Christian,
作为这个信徒的群体，
Well, as a community of believers,
你支持任何政党都不是最重要的。
Which party do you support is not important.
你要支持的圣经里面的价值有没有在我们社会里面彰显出来。
What you need to support is the value of the Bible, whether it's being manifested in the society.
要看重诚信的一个社会。
And a society that emphasizes on integrity.
一个看重要去服侍穷人的弱势群体的社会。
And a society that should serve the poor and the weak.
一些一个愿意自己付出代价去跟那些没有的人去分享的一个社会。
And a society that's willing to pay, to sacrifice, to share with the poor.
你要支持这些愿意这样做的人。
You need to support this kind of people.
我们当中希望有人可能就当议员的。
Well, some of you might hope to be a parliamentarian.
我们当然需要一些是去当牧师当传道的。
Of course, we still need the people that will be a preacher to be a pastor.
我们需要很多在教会里面你看到自己信徒但你也是一个牧者的。
Well, we also want to see that people that see yourself as a believer and yet you see yourself as a lay pastor.
每一个世代
and every generation,
上帝都呼召他的儿女。
God continues to call his children.
透过不同的途径
Through different channels,
不同的身份
different status, different identity,
见证福音的大能
so that the
power of the gospel,
the power of gospel
是一个爱与公义的福音
can be manifested through the gospel of love
and justice.
And justice.
希望我们弟兄姐妹
I hope that brothers and sisters,
我们明天要离开这里了
we're going to leave this place tomorrow.
我们都看到上帝在马来西亚做了大工。
We all see that God has done a great work in Malaysia.
我们怎样去参与？
How are we going to participate?
我们怎么令到我们的教会、我们的社会更有公义？
How are we going to help so that our church, our society, to see more justice?
有真正基督十字架的爱在我们的生活、我们的行动当中。
And there's love of Jesus Christ in our lives, in our daily lives.
我相信这个就是我们每一个人竟然有机会参与上帝的工作。
And this is a time that even us have the opportunity to participate in the work of God in this generation.
何等的荣耀。
How great, how glorious is this opportunity?
我们只是一个很微小的仆人。
We are just very humble servant.
But we could participate God's work.
但是我们也可以在这个神的工作上有份。
我们一起祷告。
Let us pray.
神啊，天父，感谢你， 因为我们的弟兄姐妹愿意付出代价来参加这个退休会。
Our Father, we thank you that brothers and sisters were willing to come to the retreat.
很多的弟兄姐妹也愿意为我们筹备了那么美好的一个退休会。
That there was such great organization.
我们能够一起生活，一起分享。
That we could live together and share with one another.
一起去聆听上帝的话语。
And to listen to your words.
主啊，求你今天晚上同样大家呼召我们弟兄姐妹。
Oh Lord, we ask you in the same way to call all of us.
让我们心里面被你的话语所感动。
That will be touched by your words.
因为我们知道在很多不同的见证人像云彩一样环绕我们。
Because we see that there are many witnesses that are just surrounding us like clouds.
我们何等的卑微。
How humble we are.
而且我们知道我们在世上的年日其实不晓得有多长或者多短。
And we don't know how long or short is our lives.
但我们希望的这么生命是能够被你所使用
But we hope our lives will be used by you
能够成为别人的祝福
There will be a blessing for others
在教会
In church
在家里
In the family
在这个社会
In this society
在这个国家里面
In this country
每一个人都能够参与上帝的工作
That all of us will have a portion in your work
求主就呼召我们当中的
Oh Lord, you call us
我特别要呼召有没有弟兄姐妹愿意在教会里面能够作为一个全时间侍奉的人
I want to call for those who are willing to serve full time in church
你愿意的话
If you're willing
你被感动的话
If you've been touched and moved
你看到像何牧师他用他的忠心的侍奉的美加堂
You saw how Reverend Ho has served God faithfully
他是上帝良善忠心的仆人
and being a good and loyal servant
他要退休了
he's going to retire
需要有更多人愿意参与这个侍奉
there need to be more people to take part in this ministry
只要你有这个感动
if you're touched
你愿意为向上帝祷告
you're willing to pray to God
主啊我在这里
Lord here I am
求你呼召
you call me
愿意这样子祷告的话你举手
You're willing to pray like this Please put up your hand
我为你祷告
I want to pray for you
有没有这样的弟兄姐妹呢
Are there brothers and sisters like this
有没有弟兄姐妹呢
Are there brothers and sisters like this
羡慕愿意做一个被上帝全时间要用你的仆人
That you're willing to be a servant A full-time servant of God
举起手来
Put up your hand
你举了以后你可以放下来
After you do that, you may put down your hand
在我们当中有没有人觉得这个社会我们马来西亚需要更多正义的议员
Well, are there any one of us that think that this society in Malaysia needs a more just parliamentarian politicians
我愿意做一个有信用的诚实的一个政治的参与者
If you like to participate and beingperson with integrity
愿意去做一个希望以后有机会做一个议员
if you wish and you would like to be a parliamentarian one day
你举起手来
put up your hand
我们为你祷告
we want to pray for you
有没有这样的弟兄姐妹
are there people like this
你举起手来
put up your hand
我们为你祷告
I want to pray for you
举手以后我可以放下来
and after you do that you can just put down your hand
肯定说我就是没有那么清楚这些的具体的呼召
You say I don't have very clear calling now
我只是一个很强烈的呼召我要侍奉主
I only have this very strong calling
无论在我的家里面
No matter in the family
在教会里面
In the church
或者社会里面
Or in the society
我只是愿意侍奉主
I'm willing to serve God
你愿意这样祷告的
Are you willing to pray like this
你举起手来
Put up your hand
看到了可以放下
I can see you
还有没有看到了可以放下
I can see you
我们一起来祷告
Let us pray
生命的主呼召我每一个人的主
Our God of life God that call us
你不单呼召我们来跟从你
Not only you've called us to follow you,
你是让我们在每天的生活里面跟从你。
You want us to follow you in our everyday lives.
在我们世上的生活来跟从你。
And in our lives that follow you.
用我们最好的时间、精神、力量来跟从你。
Use our time and energy, and money to follow you.
我们不需要人的称赞。
We don't need a praise from people.
我们不在意人重视或者不重视我们。
We do not care whether people look up to us or not.
我们要看重的是你自己。
But we look upon you.
我们要听你的话语。
We want to listen to you.
人所聪明的东西可能是愚拙的。
Well, whatever that people see is good, it might be actually foolish.
但是人看来是愚蠢的，在你看来是有智慧的。
But what might be foolish in people's eye, it might be of wisdom in you.
主啊，我们感谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
今天晚上我们看到弟兄姐妹表达他们的意愿。
Because we see people express their will.
无论他们愿全时间的当一个牧者，
whether it's to be a full-time pastor,
或他们有心愿在政治上面有更多的参与，
or to have more participation in the politics,
或他们就是有一个心愿要侍奉你的，
or the heart to serve you.
求你在每一个世代都呼召你的仆人。
We ask you to call your servant in every generation.
这些表达他们意愿的祷告，求你悦纳。
And these people that express their will, may you take them as a pleasing sacrifice.
求你加添他们力量。
May you add to their strength.
求你带领他们前面的道路。
May you lead their way forward.
我们有些其他弟兄姐妹心里面还没有感动的。
But there are these brothers and sisters that still not been prompted in their heart.
求你继续的向他们说话。
May you continue to speak to them.
继续的带领他们。
Continue to lead them.
在他们未来的日子里面。
In their days ahead.
在你的眼中是活得丰盛的。
That they will live.Abundantly in your eyes,
他们活在这个世代当中
that they live in this generation,
成为你的见证
and to be a witness,
成为你的工作的同工
and to be a co-worker of your ministry,
参与你这个在世界上的工作
and participate in the work of this world.
我们感谢主
we thank you, Lord.
你们就是我们的生命的主
you are the Lord of our lives.
我们奉主耶稣基督求
name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.